What's up, guys? Quick reminder here tonight before we get started. If you subscribe to the Brain Trust, we have some new content for you over the holidays. We had an update from Zan from Forward Progress Madden with quarterback sneak defense. We had a bonus video from MStack with pass protection from the Titans. And then after the show tonight, we'll be talking about out of position players, how you get them on special teams to max the hit power for your lineup. So if you're watching this tonight, you'll get an email after the show. And then if you're watching on YouTube tomorrow, keep an eye on your Twitch messages. And also feel free to email me, zfarles@maddentips.com. What's up, everybody? And welcome to another exciting edition of This Week in Madden Show 178. A lot of shows. We are live. Everyone's asking. We're back into flesh. We had a good holiday. We had a great break. Missed a couple sodes, but let's not waste any time. We'll get right back into it. We take your questions live on this show. We break them down. That's pretty much all we do here. So if you guys have questions, tweet them at us. You can use Twitter, @MaddenBible, @SGibs7.
Yeah, buddy.
And you can submit questions leading up to the show during the week. We've got mailbag questions coming up. We're going to jump into practice mode. First, take a look at this question here. This one is coming in from Trotsky. He wants to know, should I go with zone or man to stop the run? So that's a pretty good question. We've got sub hype in the building. We also have some new emotes in the chat. We've got a little sub train, so if you haven't checked your new emotes, check that out. But this question first from Trotsky here, zone or man to stop the run? Gibbs, what do you think about that?
I'm going to go with zone for Madden, but if we're asking a football question, even though we'll get into that, but when it comes to Madden, you definitely want to play zone because typically if you're in like a cover four, cover three, you're not in a press coverage.
Right.
The zones are back. They're backed up. The alignment is further away from the line of scrimmage. And because of that, it gives you a better chance for them to kind of avoid an incoming blocker. When you're playing man, if you're in man press, two man under, the second you run the ball, the second you go out wide and you become a ball carrier, they're already engaged with the blocker. So my opinion, I look at it as, well, if they're not already engaged right away, it gives me an opportunity to get a win in that situation. So I prefer zone. Just overall, in general, I prefer zone.
And that's a really actually a good question, and I think you enlightened it pretty well. So we'll show you an example. Once again, zone or man to stop the run. So I'm going to come out in a strong pro formation here on This Week in Madden. You've got off tackle. So you're saying zone coverage, the defenders are backed off the line of scrimmage.
Yes.
In man coverage, they're generally more towards the line of scrimmage. So in real football, it's nice that they're up near the line of scrimmage.
Correct.
But what actually happens in Madden when you call man coverage is they get blocked because they're standing so close guy about to block them.
Yeah, there's the man. Obviously, if you play a cover zero style blitz, they're going to be back. Your safeties are up, so that's helpful. But in general, a better way to look at this is typically if you play any type of over-the-top coverage, like a cover two man, cover four, like anything with two man under style, like defense with the name in the play call, you're going to have the defenders up, and that's going to help the offense get a blocker on your defender.
So what would be your optimal run defensive setup? Say, we'll start with off tackle because this is a pretty popular run. There's three runs we should probably look at real fast and kind of give your thoughts on zone or man. Off tackle, toss, and inside zone. So for off tackle, what do you think? Well, like to slide your guys out?
The first thing I want to do is I take a look at the strong side of the formation, and the strong side is you want to take a look where the tight end is. So in this instance, you can see Gronkowski is on the right side of the field. So typically what I would do is, in this instance, you can see the corner over here is in a flat. Typically in a cover three, they're in a deep zone there, and then the safety would be in the flat.
Mm-hmm.
So what I would do is I would bring the safety down as an extra defender in the box. I'd get him wide out here just because I don't want him too far back and then have you have a complete – like, if I don't have the safety off this edge, it's what I always call false confidence. Like, if you saw that, you get, oh, juicy,
oh,
baby.
I can hit that edge,
ooh,
yeah.
I can get there. And whether it's defended against or not, it gives you confidence, and that's half the battle. So the second that I can, say, come out in that cover three again, and I move the safety that's in the flat, I get him out wide in the slot, And then it gives me some hope from you.
All of a sudden, that edge isn't looking so appealing, and he actually does come in to make the play. Sometimes he doesn't actually make a play, but he actually made the play right there, which is really nice.
Correct.
So that's pretty big. You don't want to give people that false confidence. It's the same thing with like a tight end streak. If you take away that linebacker Hewitt and slide him out there, well, all of a sudden I'm just like, you know what? I'm going to streak Gronk.
Yeah.
I'm going to streak Gronk.
Right.
Close my eyes.
And throw it to him. And you completed it.
I completed it. I had my eyes closed.
Right.
Which I once played a game of all Madden with a bag on my head and I still won. But
you're a good
player. Just don't want to give him the confidence. Even if that guy stands there, you might still complete it, but you don't want the person to think, I can probably complete this.
Right. So back to the initial part about the strong side of the formation. So really what you want to do is find the strong side of the formation and make sure you have an extra defender in that area. So that's where you bring the safety down. And say if you're not going to bring the safety, something that you could simply do is if you shift your linebackers. Maybe that's an advanced tip, but if you do RB on the on your Xbox One controller and then push the D-pad to the right, now you're going to see that you're moving that linebacker off the right edge. And this is getting to that point where you now control the line of scrimmage. The offense doesn't have the advantage now with the extra blocker, and it's harder for you to get wide.
I'm going to say you called it an advanced tip. I want the advanced guys in the chat are going to be like,
correct,
that's a noob tip. But the noobs are like, that was an advanced tip.
Right.
And it's something that if you're an advanced player, you might have 40 steps to stop this play with your advanced blitz, set up this gap, blitz that guy, re-blitz that guy, do all this jazz. But all you might have simply had to do was shift the linebackers by RB left on the D-pad and actually make a real front, and then you're at least controlling the gaps.
Listen, if I'm going to want to really stop this, if I'm going to give you an advanced tip of how I would defend this, I would, for the most part, it's any formation two men under, and it's show blitz. In that instance, like in this here, I would probably blitz the safety. And what I have now is I have a complete overload of the online scrimmage, and I can shoot any gap I want. So a snap of the ball, I can just get wide out here, and I'm in the gap, and you went through. But like it's what you see I do from the nickel 335 odd.
You muddy, you block every gap, correct, and then that gives you lanes to shoot through to try and tackle the defender in the backfield. And you like man for that a little bit.
Right, so maybe I would blitz the safety there. So when you literally take a look at this, it's a hat on a hat. So you have with the show blitz. So it's Jenkins would take the left tackle. Vernon takes a left guard. Mitchell takes a center. Sue takes the right guard. Hewitt takes the right tackle. And then Shelby takes the right the tight end. My safety takes the fullback. Or if you run up in the middle of the field here, see the gap right there?
Right.
Like I was on the safety. But that's the whole entire point of using show blitz and getting extra defenders up in the box. You want a hat and a hat. So it gives you a lane to shoot through and attack the ball carrier. And that's going to work whether it's, you know, if you audible to halfback dive from the set. Do you have that halfback blast? Like,
I do have a dive. Yes.
So check this, right? So snap of the ball. Go ahead. Right there. So I would need the safety inside because the fullback came and got me. Or I could go like this. I could go to two man. Right. This safety goes here. I could rush Shepard here. Through. So this is very similar to double clamp go. So I could, so look, it looks a lot like double clamp go. If I go here with eight.
My bad.
If I go there with the safety there and blitz through those gaps, the number of guys I have in line of scrimmage, I'm going to overload and I should shoot a guy in hopefully free. And the beauty of it is I'm not blitzing too many people. Like, you're still going to have pretty good coverage. Like, everyone's manned up besides the fullback there. So snap of the ball. Right there. Hat and a hat. We get in. We make the play. So it's very simple what's happening, but it's all, I mean, really, it's math. It's math.
Yeah, no, I mean, that's a good general overview of run defense right there. I think that will help a lot of people. And you mentioned about you prefer man.
No, I prefer zone.
You prefer zone in Madden, man in real life, just because more defenders are up in the box. In Madden, if your defenders are too close to the guy they're guarding, they'll just get blocked at the snap of the ball is what you're thinking.
Mm-hmm.
In zone, you can kind of bluff a lot of guys up to the line of scrimmage, kind of lay things out, and it will work out for you. So good first question right there of the night. Let's run to the chat real quick. We've got a lot of sub hype in the building. Shugs is back. D Stu is back. We might have missed a couple others, but I just want to give a shout out to everyone for bringing it back in. Some big ones. 11 months for Shugs in the house. And Delray with the 13. That's going to get you in the Conductor's Club.
That's an intense sub train.
Quite chunk right there.
That's an intense up train.
Delray, I'm putting you on the conductor club. That's what's up. All right, here we go.
TWU, that's what's up.
Let's take a look at the next question in the mailbag, and we'll take it from N. Lanza. So he wants to know, what stats matter most for each position on the offensive line? And this is a good question because it's essential in every lineup and in every mode to kind of get your offensive line set how you want it. The Pats, I say, do it better than any others because in real life, they actually use so many different combinations. And you can do this in Madden if you know what ratings to look for. What do you think?
Well, let's start with inside out. So if we're going to take a look at the most important ratings for offensive linemen in Madden NFL 16, you can see right here we have two centers. The very first thing I look for, no matter what, for every single offensive lineman is I go directly to strength. And for example, you have David Andrews here in Stork. They're very low in strength, so I immediately think, like, if I face a 3-4 set, I'm going to struggle. I might need to run a fullback scheme because what ends up happening with these strength ratings when they're low is if you go against a stronger defensive lineman.
Especially a D-tackle who's right. going to be lined up there. Known to be very strong, obviously.
Right. And if you say it's Ndamukong, for example, right, who we'll be playing with later in the game of the week.
At quarterback.
But if he has 96 strength, 95 strength, he's going to win that point of attack battle and push your lineman back. It doesn't mean on every single play, but the rating 80 versus the strength rating of the defensive lineman is going to match up. So I always look at strength first. That's my first thing I look at. And if I see a guy with high strength, I immediately say, okay, this guy can suit up and play my team.
Because he can hold the line.
He can hold the line. It doesn't mean he's going to hold it long. Okay, there's other ratings that matter for that, but it does mean that he will potentially have a chance to hold it for not get pushed back, or he'll push forward if he's
right.
very strong.
Right.
The next thing I look at, and this is the inside-out approach, I go directly to run block, pass block after that. So it's strength and then run back, pass block.
Pretty important to note, there was a blog on the EA site a year or two ago. We can dig through and try and find the link, but it's more important run block, pass block. There's some footwork stuff. That's more for simulation, for deeper modes like CFM and stuff. For gameplay, I believe you stick to run block and pass block, and that's what matters. Impact block does too. It's tertiary. It's like a third thing we look for, depending on the role. But run block, pass block are the important ones, these two here.
Yeah, so run block, what that is saying is in an instance where there's a blog. If we can find it, we can mention it out to you. Maybe someone in the chat.
I can find it tomorrow.
Maybe Wolf Mania. Sure. Somebody, we could put it out later. It details out what run block, pass block mean, but I'll paraphrase for you here. So run block, what it actually represents is like how long the offensive lineman is going to hold that block for.
Against
block shed. So think, okay, now couple this together. Get ready. You have strength, which is push back or move forward or neutral. Those are the kind of like the three scenarios, right? Then you have run block, which is going to depend how long you're going to hold that versus block shed in the run. So you say you have a low strength and you have a low run block as an offensive lineman, you're going to get pushed back most likely, and you're going to have a block shed where you're not going to hold that block on running plays. That's a terrible formula.
Bad gum.
But say you have a very strong offensive lineman and his run block is low, you have a chance that you might win that battle up front, but then the block gets beat.
Yes.
Where that can become a benefit to you is that you might not lose yards at the point of attack. You may only get 1 yard, 2 yards. Where the problem is, the low strength guys can cause you to lose yards consistently. So that's, to me, strength is the most important. And that same thing goes for pass block with finesse move and power move.
Mm-hmm.
So that's to me is, I think strength is the most important rating I look at. And then I go run block, pass block. The last one here, impact block. What that's for is kicking out blocks. So
yeah,
talk to me a little about guards and
crosses. Yeah, so you got a guard, and say it's a 0-1 trap, and the guard's going to pull, or it's a toss, and they got to get out there. Speed will factor in a little bit, excel a little bit. They got to get out there. But once they meet a defender who's moving towards them, impact block will kind of determine if they're going to kind of get the pancake or how well they're going to block those defenders in space. Two moving players meet, impact block factors in. I'm not sure what it is for defense. Might just be block shed still. But, unless you're putting the guy in that role, not really too concerned about it. Like it for fullbacks. This is really helpful, especially in ultimate teams. So, the tip would be, if the Patriots do it, Stork, since their strength is basically the same, you would start Stork when you want to run the ball, and you'd start Andrews when you want to pass the ball.
Supplement on third down.
Yeah. And so you can kind of follow that formula, and it's a great way to find budget guys, especially early in the season. You go get yourself a big, strong Mackenzie Bernadou run blocker who can't pass block, or a Mike Iapati. Until a legend comes out, that's kind of more balanced across the board. Then you go and get yourself a guy who's a true pass blocker. And you got to remember, interior linemen, generally weaker than tackles, yes. Generally stronger because they're bigger. So you're not going to find a lot of strong centers. So don't be too concerned about that.
Right. And now this is, we went over the first like four, and really those are the four that really mattered the most. But then there's these other stats. What was the word you used? Tertiary.
Yeah. Never heard. I tried it. I don't know. I said it the other week and nobody called me out.
Here's the thing. The next right thing I look at is I look at the combination of speed, agility, and acceleration to kind of get an understanding of how well I might be able to run like a horizontal run game when if it comes to like tosses, if it comes to sweeps, power O's, things where you get halfback screens, right? So I see Stork, 57 speed, yuck. I see acceleration, okay. But then you see Andrews. We already now know he's better in the run blocking game. Was that right?
So he was the pass blocker.
So he's a pass blocker. So he's going to be good for screens, acceleration. You know, you might not want, even though Stork, but he's a center, so he's not going to go out into any other than screens. So you get a feel for the player, how good they're going to be on tosses because of their speed, agility, and acceleration. It was like that. What's that guy on the Raiders a couple years ago? Bruce Campbell. He was like 78 speed and like 95 acceleration.
Yeah, Maryland offensive lineman was like a monster. Plus, you could probably put him at tight end if you had to. And that's the other thing you can do with your linemen, is throw him at the sixth tight end, bring in sixth offensive lineman spot, put it at tight end, get a whole extra blocker in the run game. Especially in play now. It's not as important as muck because you can find tight ends that can block, but that's what I find important. And those are the key ratings to look for when you choose an offensive lineman.
And it doesn't really change across the board, really. Like, you can look, you could say you might value speed, agility, and acceleration a little more for guards because they're the only guys that are pulling. Like, you don't typically have a tight end. I don't think there's any play in the game that has a tight end or a tackle pulling.
The Niners have, like, a couple because they have Joe Staley.
Gotcha.
He's really good. But you'd have to, I don't even think it's a good run because, like, strong power might have last year, but inside zones.
How about that Saint screen? Remember the Saint screen from iForm a couple years
ago? You want it to be good, but it's terrible.
Every year.
Saints playbook, bells and whistles.
iForm tight.
Yeah.
Saints halfback screen.
All right, here we go. We'll keep digging through the mailbag here. Gibbs, anybody, any interesting stuff in the chat you got going on?
They're having great discussions. They're having great discussions in there. Yeah,
they're pumped.
They're going back and forth. We got guys like Hold Fast Hope. We got Killa, TX Whispers, Big Man Awesomeness, D Stew, WE Net Gaming, all the dudes in here, they're all talking about offensive linemen.
Offensive linemen it is. That's what's going on. All right, next question in the mailbag. This one is from Salty Pretzel, and he wants to know, can you guys rate your co-host as a Madden player and reveal your ratings on the show? So the categories would be overall, scheming and labbing, stick skills, adjustments, and clock management.
Is that a real question?
I promise you I didn't make that up.
I'm going to need you to bring that up back up at
all
some
right,
point.
So overall, scheming. So you want me to rate you real fast?
I don't want my overall yet.
Okay. So scheming and labbing, I'm going to make you a 97
mm-hmm.
out of 99.
Mm-hmm.
Stick skills, I'm going to give you a B-.
What? That's not, no, you have to give me a rating.
A through F grade.
You have to give me a number rating.
All right. Your stick skills, 79. For adjustments, I'm going to give you a 93, and I'll tell you why mm-hmm. later. Clock management, 46 overall. All right. What do you got for me here?
What'd you give me as an overall? What am I an overall?
Overall, you are a 87.
That's it?
Solid B+.
Wow. All right.
That's higher than any grade you ever got in high school. So
that's true.
Pretty good.
That's not true. All right. Now, this is what I give Farles for my grade. Can you pull up the... Yep. Thank you very much. Your scheming and labbing is a 12 because that's the lowest you can go. You are the worst schemer and labber on the history of the planet.
I'm going to disagree, but that's okay.
You know what? Listen, maybe you can scheme... No. You are a freestyle player, so therefore you do no scheming and you do no labbing. So that's why I give you a 12.
I disagree, but that's
stick
okay.
skills, I'm going to give you a 99. I'm not giving you 100 because No one really ever deserves 100, but you're 99 stick skills. You have great stick skills.
Thank you.
Always have. You always will. You're the computer. Everyone knows that. Adjustments, I'm going to give you a 91 because I think you're better than a 90. You're not above an A-.
Because sometimes I take lax.
Like, adjustment-wise, I can look at it two ways. I'm choosing to look at it in the vein that, like, you are very good playing freestyle and just doing random stuff.
The mole.
Right. If this question was, labbing adjustments or, like, scheme adjustments,
setups.
I would... Setups. If it was setups, I would give you a 65.
Yes.
Clock management, I'm going to go ahead and give you an 85. You're good. You're very solid, but I have seen you many times mess up clock management.
I tell you what. I've been botching it more than ever before.
Yeah.
Because you play so many muck games that the situation's like you're not paying as much. You play your seventh muck game of the day. You're like, yeah. Oh, it's the second quarter. Oh, I probably should have called a timeout. Like, whereas you just play one or two games a day. You're like, when I watch the NFL, I still, you know, I know the clock situations, but I. You know, you're streaming, you're hanging, you're chatting in the chat. It's pretty tough.
All right, so here's what you got. Overall, you're an 87 because you can't be worse than me, you can't be better than me. So you're an 87 overall.
True. I will say one of the reasons I gave you a little bit lower on on adjustments.
Yeah, why?
Because I think you over-adjust sometimes. And I think you also, like, overthink what you're thinking. Like, you're the opposite of me. You always have that eighth setup handy to bring that
ready
double B gap one time a game backside pressure that you practiced. But sometimes you overdo that, and just when a simple adjustment, you get beat by thinking too much.
You're 100% sabotage ready.
It happens. So good questions there. Good to think about your game, where your strengths are, where your weaknesses
are. Wait, you gave me a 79 stick skills?
I don't know, did I?
That's really low.
No, I don't think I did.
Yeah.
We'll check
someone
the tape.
In the chat just said.
The other question is, what are your goals for 2016 in Madden NFL franchise?
Mine?
Well? Yeah.
My goal
and is, the chat's goals, I'd like to know.
Just in general, I'll say my Madden goals, my Madden NFL 16, Madden NFL 17, whatever you want to call it. My goal would be to become a better teacher. To better understand the exact problems that people are having in the community.
Yell at you.
When do I ever yell at you?
We're not friends. I said yell at your friends less.
Do you see how mean he is?
No.
Do you see how mean he is to me? That, like that right there, that hurts. That hurts. That hurts. That hurts my soul. Okay? But as I was saying, I want to learn more. I have a good base understanding of where we can help the community, but just in general, become a better teacher. To help you guys succeed and enjoy the game more. Those are my goals.
Indeed. If you guys have goals of your own, let's post those in the Brain Trust group, and we can all work together towards achieving them. Some guys are looking to compete in tournaments. Other guys are looking to win their CFMs. Other guys are looking to just beat their friends. Some guys are just trying to put together a mutt team where they can win. It all depends on where you want to be. Wolfman wants to beat me by 21. It's going to take a lot of training. But
Wolfman already beat you this year, bro. That's true. Fact.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Everyone's beat everybody. You know, it's a good community.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about.
Yeah.
So think about your goals and let us know in the Brain Trust group.
Great question from Salty Press. I'd appreciate if we got more questions like that.
Yeah, Rice Cake wants to be top 64. I like that. All right, this is a question we get probably once a year, and we got to put it to rest. Does slide protection do anything for run plays? So let's actually go into game, and we'll take a look and prove that it does not do anything. There is one situation, though, Gibbs, where slide protection does work for you.
That's true.
And that will be on halfback draws. So we'll take a look at a halfback draw and look at the blocking.
Yeah. You know, the chat is just coming to my defense here. Uncle Momo, Gibbs is better than Farrell's. That's what I thrive off that. I thrive off
He
that.
Must have missed the nine times I beat you this year.
How come you don't play me anymore?
Because you never ask.
That's not true. I'm not your friend, so that's why I don't ask.
Okay. So we're not friends.
See that hurts? See how that hurts?
Didn't hurt.
You see how that...
Oh, good. All right, so you see the play art right now. I'm in halfback draw. I'm going to push LB and then flick the right stick to the left. And you'll notice the play art has now changed to the left. If I flick it to the right, it's going to block to the right. It's going to slide protect. So we'll actually run this with slide protection to the left, and It's because halfback draws use pass blocking because it's technically you're trying to, like, fake the computer into thinking you're going to run the ball. Here is a slants play. I'm going to pass for slide protect to the left. Same thing happens. Now, if I go to the inside zone and then see how the blocking angles are much different, I'm going to slide protect to the left. Notice nothing changes. Slide protect to the right. Notice nothing changes. I'm going to actually slide protect to the left. Let's see if they... I mean, 61's going to jump out at the left tackle no matter what. So let's say I slide protect to the right. Let's just see if 61, you know, doesn't slide out. No, he does. So there's no slide protection on
there, run plays. And this, again, we tell this to the community every year.
And then some guy, there's always one guy in the chat and he goes, but I do it and it's real. I promise.
We're telling you it's absolutely not.
I swear.
It's only a quarterback draws. This is something that people debated for years. I think it was dispelled like 3 or 4 years ago from Clint. I believe so, at an E3 or something.
But where's the guy who's like, no, I do it, though. I do it.
He'll show up. He'll show up.
He'll be here. Yeah. Hopefully he pops up on YouTube.
Right.
But slide general, protection, not for run plays.
In general, don't lose sleep over thinking about, like, should I do that? Should I not do it? At the end of the day, I guess it doesn't really hurt to do it. If it makes you feel better, do it.
True. I don't hate it. But yeah, you can try those draws. But once again, draws not a great run. Inside zone, great run.
And there it is, Floppy D-Box. But he's just kidding, buddy. Appreciate that. Shout out to King of Kings Gaming, following the channel.
And shout out to the people watching us on YouTube, all confused. Like, how do I follow? You just hit the sub button on YouTube. That's all it takes. All right. Let's keep going through the mailbag here. We've got loads of questions. You can also send your questions in to Twitter to get them answered. All right. Mr. Jenkins. What's the best defensive back lineup in your opinion? So if we're talking about Ultimate Team here, if you had to choose defensive backs, who are you taking in your lineup?
I can take anybody.
Any
lineup. All right, I'm going to take it. I mean, it's any lineup. You have Deion Sanders, 1. You have Darrell Revis, 2. You have Night Train Lane, 3. You have Patrick Peterson, Team of the League, 4.
I didn't say what is your lineup. I said what is the best lineup.
That is the best lineup.
Is that your lineup?
Yes, that's my lineup.
It's a good lineup. Gibbs' lineup, I'm going to say, relies a little bit on specific defense, the 3-3-5 odd, which is a great defense.
I change it out. I'll change it out. But
if you want to play man coverage, that's the lineup. If you want to play zone coverage, I'm going to recommend you get Night Train Lane opposite the Deion, and then probably freeze Norman in the slot.
Yeah, you could go another Norman, too, if you want.
And you could stack another Norman, maybe a Rondé Barber at the 4. It's up to you. But
Team of the Week, Sherman.
Every lineup's going to contain Night Train and Deion, I would say, if you really want the best. At safety, it's a little bit different because there's a lot of people that some like to use their safeties, some don't like to use their safeties.
Right.
You know, Dawkins, Ed Reed, all those guys, they're the best safeties in the game, but they still only have 94 zone coverage. So you can also... If you wanted to play all-out zone coverage, cover 4 style, you can get a 98 zone coverage Rondé Barber and a Norman and put them at safety if it's a passing situation. They're not going to be as good at tackling. But you got to think about those situations that they're going to be in. If you're playing two-man under, man coverage, you do want those guys in deep zones still rated high in zone.
Yes. So, and the other thing to think about, too, is like your safeties. You can shy away with your safeties on man coverage. You could get away with it because most times you're not going to be blitzing like... We don't recommend to blitz from cover 0, I guess is more so what I'm saying. Right. So your safeties don't typically have to play man. It's a nice-to-have thing where maybe you're on the fly in zone. You can make a quick adjustment and man them up on somebody. But generally speaking, if you're looking to save some coin, don't go for the guy like a Earl Thomas. Like, don't go for an Earl Thomas that has a combination of both but not really super elite in either.
Yeah.
Just go for the guy that's elite in zone. Like a Glover Quinn could be a guy. Yeah. Like, so, we always talk about.
And then people are asking about the best budget lineup, and that's going to be super man and zone specific. You don't want to have both because then you're going to have to pay for both. Man coverage, you should get a Ronald Darby, to the playoffs. You should get a Team of the Week, Robert Alford. You should get... There's a new CB that just came out this week, 17 Team of the Week. There's a CB. Grab him. There's a Jason Verrey that's really good. There's a Bradley Roby Team of the Week that's good. All those guys are budget. Safety, you obviously have the Glover Quinn, 92, who you can pick up. Aloka has a new item that's pretty good at strong safety. Zone coverage-wise, Ron Parker, I think, is a 75. David 75K. David Amerson's pretty inexpensive. And good. there's a lot of guys that have like 91 speed, 94 zone. There's like a Tillman's a little bit more. You kind of want to get one guy that's, you know, really the guy for CB, and then you can kind of. I like to have more that are equal across the board rather than paying for Richard Sherman, who's nasty in zone, but then having like really weaker guys at 2, 3, and 4 because of that, if you do that. So.
All right, we got a good question from C-Girl in the chat. Yeah. He said, 500K, three corners, free safety, strong safety. Free safety, I'm telling you, go Glover Quinn.
Yeah.
Right away. If you look at corners... Corners are, you got to pay a premium for them.
Yeah, they're pricey. They're pricey.
Let's see. I like the Carl. I like maybe potentially going Carlos Rogers.
I think you can get better value.
Probably get better value. Yeah. But I think
he is good though.
He's looking for a top end. That's a good question. Let me come back.
Sam Shields, man. I tell you what, Sam Shields for 140.
Yeah.
He balls. He definitely balls.
Yeah, he's good.
He's fast. He's got zone and man. He's
you go
really
this,
nice.
You go this Dominic Rogers-Cromartie.
He's a man
you go,
guy.
You go
for
Captain
sure.
Rogers-Cromartie, Sam Shields.
Yeah.
That's going to get you to about 300K.
But then are you too much man, too much zone? You know?
Yeah.
You got Norman. So it's really up to you, but those that's the 200K range, guys. We gave you the cheaper guys. There's a Malcolm Butler that's good. There's a Gilmore. Team of the week, I believe it is, or Football Outsiders. He's really good, so there's definitely some options to pick up in your lineup. 88 Tlaib, I don't love. Football Outsiders, Jimmy Smith, very good. The Peters is really good, and those are some guys you want for your team. You absolutely want the Peters on your lineup. And those are some recommendations for budget DBs. We can keep exploring those, guys. We go over those every time we're live on the channel, so make sure to give it a follow. Because we do talk about this stuff quite a bit, and people in the chat know their lineups too and are very helpful. Next question in the mailbag from Jubers. He wants to know, what is one passing play that should be in everyone's arsenal? And he said, not including like screen passes and kind of stuff he knows. So let's take a look for a passing play that should be in everyone's arsenal. I am in the Patriots. Mm-hmm. The gun split close has some passing plays that should be in everyone's arsenal. The Z-spot play is a play I think should be in. You obviously have the man-beating route to the left with the quick throw. You have the streak, flat, and quarter combo. So that's a play you should definitely have in your arsenal. From Gun Ace, though, I would recommend the play Hitch Corners. I think this is a play that not enough people run. So if it ends up being man coverage, what you have is two corner routes. What I would do is drag a receiver.
Mm-hmm.
Either one doesn't really matter.
Yep.
You're probably better off streaking Amendola because then you could. It's probably better to throw to LaFell downfield than it is to throw to Amendola.
Mm-hmm.
But you should be able to win on Gronk's cut. He is a tight end. He won't get pressed. He's probably going to be matched up against a linebacker for the most part. So you can't get these corner routes any other way. You need this play. The other thing I would do is probably option route the halfback.
I mean, the key here, I think, what you're going for is against man, you can potentially, with emotional foul, you get four guys, five guys all free from press.
Correct.
And that's the whole important, that's the key.
A lot of unbumpables. It's a good man-beating play. If you have to beat zone, it's also a quick audible, which is nice. You do have to come out in the inside zone because the draw is the quick audible.
So let's just talk real quick about why it's important that you can beat man from every single route here. So what happens with man is like the timing get slowed down because of the press, and then you don't get the great release. So when you have all these tight ends and these drags, so with this setup right here, what I would love to see you do here, Farrell, instead of running a corner to Chandler, like you're going to motion LaFell, but put Chandler on an out. Just put him on a quick out, motion LaFell. So now it ends up
motion
happening.
Snap LaFell?
Yeah, a couple steps and snap up. So everyone's free, and then as soon as he cuts, you can throw it to him. You could hit the drag underneath. You could put him on a zig. You could put him on an in. You could put him on a slant. So there's a lot of things you can do to really slow down your opponent and like be fresh with every single play where you're going to go with the ball.
Right, pretty important. So by motioning him, he won't get pressed. Streaks will usually get pressed. This tight end route will never get pressed because he's on the line of scrimmage. He's nobody aligned over him. Same thing with Gronk. He's there. Halfback out of the backfield won't get pressed. And then drags don't get pressed. So that's five routes can't be pressed. And that's one you want to have in your arsenal. That's a good play from the Patriots playbook.
Pretty good.
What is up in the CHAT, the chat?
We are chatting in the chat.
Guys, reminder, if you sub tonight, keep an eye on your Twitch messages. That is how you're going to get the content and get into the Facebook group. Anybody on YouTube, you can also email me, zfarles@maddentips.com, if for some reason you're not getting a message. Zan has new QB sneak defense. MStack has all of these Titan stuff in here, which is good. All of it is very, very legit. So you're going to want to check that out. Pass protection video talks a lot about how to slide, when to slide, why to slide, what to look for from blitzers, and how you pick up some of the popular pressures. So it's really, really good stuff. And then you've got my budget teardown sheet, which should help a lot of players get their lineup set in Ultimate Team. All right, here we go, Gibbs. Next question.
Pow.
No Name wants to know, does pass commit hurt when playing the run? So, if you pass commit, does it hurt you when you're playing against the ground game?
The answer is an emphatic yes. You thought I was going to say no. You guys thought I was going
to
say no.
He just wants to not get beat by play action is why he does it, but he doesn't want to now. Now he's thinking it might hurt him in the run a little bit.
It's absolutely going to hurt you in the run. It's the same thing as if you don't rush enough pass rushers. Like if so in this example, let me reset the play here. So if I go pass commit, there's a likelihood that I'm going to get Pancake City population my defense. And look how they get blown off the ball. Because the idea with this, guys, is if you pass commit, your defense should technically be on their heels at the snap of the ball. Like, yeah. They're not physically going to be on that in the game.
They kind of do, though.
Kind of.
He didn't as much, but he might have. They tend to drift if they're in zone coverage,
right.
I find.
Totally. That was a man there. But see how they get blown up because the offensive linemen get like the running head start and I mean, I like it. It's if you're expecting pass and then you run, that's why teams run draws on third down. Like it's third and 15. The reason they run a hot quarterback draw because it's safe, conservative, and then if a defense is completely bailed out to run pass defense in real life and they're not protecting against the short part of the field, the draw can gash them.
So you got no pass commit here.
No pass commit here.
So you're still, I mean, I'm still going to get good blocking,
right?
Just because there's not guys lined up in the gaps. But maybe if you show blitz and line them up a little closer, we'll see if I still will get quite as much push.
Not as much.
Not as much. Plus, they don't back away. You don't want to pass.
The other thing is when you like in this instance, these linebackers are far away. So watch if I move them back here, your guards are going to get a running like they're not ever back there. But when they're here, linebacker depth, and if I pass commit. The guard's got a chance to run at them and win the point of attack. So that's where you see that push. But when you are in show blitz, that's what I was talking about before. When you're in show blitz and you guys get defenders up in the belly of the defense, there's no momentum there. They just run into a guy like and they don't get the like. Shaq Mason got a little bit of a push there. I'm guessing maybe because that strength matchup against that linebacker.
Guys, and I will admit I'm a recovering addict from pass committing. I used to pass commit every single snap last year. I didn't feel like it had too much of a negative impact. This year, I'm getting pushed back. I'm getting blown up. It's bad. It's something you really, really, really only want to do in passing down situations. You got to really kind of know the pass is coming. Or if they run, even if you pass commit that, they won't be able to pick it up. So like third and 15. As somebody who has fallen for a trap, you don't want to pass commit before the snap.
Here's what I'll say, though.
On run play.
It's I don't see the play action type of passing game as effective as it was last year.
Right.
One thing I really enjoyed about last year's game was all those little inside zones off of the play action plays that everyone run, like the crossing patterns. And that's what we used to run in the beginning of the year from the Eagles Eagles bunch.
Yeah.
And you had the crossers. I really like that mind game because you have like you don't want to pass commit because you're going to get torched in the run. But then it's like it's third and six. They might run. They could go play action. They go play action. I'm going to get torched because my linebackers are going to bite potentially on the play fake.
Right.
So I like a little bit of what that brought to the table.
I watched a little bit of Super Bowl 40, I guess it was, maybe. I'm not sure the exact number, but it was might have been in the 30s. Seahawks against Steelers.
Yep.
And it was like a third and
four,
and they handed the ball to Max Strong on third and four.
Crazy.
Troy Polamalu shot. I was like, Troy Polamalu has played in this game? Wow. Because I know the Steelers made like three Super Bowls, and you're used to seeing him in there, but I'm like, wow, he was in this one. There's probably Seahawks in the fans like, we got robbed in that game, bro. But not their most heartbreaking defeat.
Right.
But, yeah, they handed the ball to Max Strong on third and four. It's like, wow, the Seahawks just ran on third and four. Like, that took,
crazy.
That took stones.
Also in that game, Matt Hasselbeck, also who was playing quarterback for the Colts this year.
Yeah. And, like, Jackson was their main receiver. Ingram. They had crazy.
Loaf,
I was just looking at the Ross.
Loaf T? Like, Lofotutupu?
This is crazy.
Remember Lofotutupu?
Oh, yeah. But, yeah, those are what you don't want to do. All right, here we go. We got another question. This time from Red Viper. He wants to know the best defense in the Pats D-book to come out in. So, he may be new to the stream. He might not know how much we love the Patriots defensive book. Yep. But what would you recommend to come out in?
I would say base. I would realistically say 3-4 odd, a.k.a. 3-4 normal. I would go cover 3 QB contain. That's going to give you 2 flats, 3 hooks over the middle of the field, 3 deep in the secondary. You're going to have a lot of coverage. You could maybe even go quarter cover 4 QB contain. I only say that because that's going to give you the best coverage. You don't necessarily need to, a beginner style defense, you don't need to worry about dialing up blitzes. We can give you that once you progress to that. And luckily, it's already in the defensive playbook for the Patriots with the nickel 3-3-5 odd. I also love big dime 1-4-6 for pass.
So, that's kind of a good base answer is that 3-4 odd you talked about. What we use is the 3-3-5 odd, which is in the brain trust, the blitzes and stuff like that we use. It helps stop inside zone, helps bring pressure from the right side. It gives you a solid zone coverage behind it, but requires more kind of advanced usering. Big dime 1-4-6 is a formation I'm comfortable with, but I'm not going to say that's a true base formation. It is, but it's like a base pasty. I consider you have your base D that you would come out in to get a feel for the offense, and then mm-hmm. you'd have like your base run D when it's like second and four or first and 10, and you think they're going to run. Like you have your base run D, which is more like a 3-4 or a nickel. And then you have your base pasty, which is more like a nickel or a dime.
Mm-hmm.
And if you can find that one nickel formation that gives you great flexibility and can kind of stop the run and can kind of stop the pass and you can feel comfortable in it and making adjustments, that's what you want to find. That's what you should be looking for in any playbook. But the Pats is unique because it does have that formation that nobody else has, a 3-3-5 odd. Plus, it has 3-4 and 4-3, which nobody else has. So I'm sure it's probably confusing for you, but 3-4 odd is good, especially if you're a beginner. And then you can kind of base, is it a base run or is it a base pass? What do I think? What's the situation? What's the downs? What's my opponent like to do?
All right, chat. We want to ask you, we want to know from you now, what do you guys think is the best base defense?
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be in the Patriots playbook, but let us know in the chat. What do you think the best base defense is in the game? Give us formation and play. And if you can, if you have the gusto there, tell us why you think it's the best base formation and defensive play in the game.
When at gaming, so in the chat, guys, hit us up in the comments too. We got when at gaming 2-4-5 cover 3 when it. That's a great formation.
3-3-5 cover 3 buzz. Yeah,
it allows you to contain. It gets plenty of linebackers out there. The zones fan out really nice. Same thing with Jackson Lee's 3-3-5 cover 3 buzz. Same thing, cover 3. You guys are hearing that it's cover 3. It's kind of a good hybrid between the two things.
Long live Simba just going.
Young
Dowers
with me.
Commit.
He likes the 1-4-6 2 man under and cover 4. He likes to mix those two up. A lot of guys like the 3-3-5 odd as the brain trust guys.
Hey guys, anyone in here, and maybe you're new to the channel, new to the show, if you see a formation that you see in this in the chat that you like, message the guy or link up with him and see what you guys can come up with. Talk, communicate. Like, you know, we have a couple guys in here that say they both like the 4-3 under formation. You know, Jay Fuller and 5-5 tool stud, right? Link up, start talking, and communicate. See how you can maybe lab together, scheme, and come up with a good defense.
Do it up. All right, Gibbs, a couple more mailbag questions. We'll also head over to Twitter in a minute and check twitter.com/MaddenBible, at MaddenBible, at SGibbs7. See if you guys hit us up with any questions that you didn't get in the mailbag in time tonight. Good formations out of the Patriots offense other than the gun split close. So, and he also said gun doubles too. So gun doubles would be the second formation I would tell you to go check out. But Zach Rias wants to know, good formations out of the Patriots offense other than the split close. So I'm in the Pats O right here.
Got something good for you right away. We can give a little mini scheme for you. We've talked about it many times. I've played against it a couple times. One specific guy on the Mutt leaderboards in the All Madden rankings. Keep going over, going over. Pat Wing's trips. Yes, this is the formation. So let me first talk about what I love about this formation so much. Halfback power. Very good. It has the same type of run and ability as like an inside zone. You might not think it does, or actually it might be the 5-6 trap. 5-6 trap. It's the 5-6 trap. It gives you that same cutting ability as inside zone.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely love that it had go down again. I love the PA patch cross.
Yep, you got play action. Quick out to the left, and you get play action blocking.
And a tight end blue.
And tight end on a delay.
And a crosser that's very difficult to get. So I love that play mixed in. I like the Pats Y out with the wheel route to the right, and you have the deep post combo. A short post on the left side of the field. Go down again on the play call. Go down. I love Pats slot Y out. We can show you that in a minute. Go down again. Go down again.
A lot of plays.
Yeah, go down again. Sorry.
No, it's cool.
Actually, keep going. I missed the play. I'm not finding where it is. We're looking for it looks like a post turns into a corner when you motion it to the left.
I see.
Keep going. Pat slot out. It's Pat slot out.
My bad.
Yeah, my bad. So this is specifically why I like this formation so much. So this is someone did this to me when I was playing, right? So if you take a look at LaFell's route right here, you motion him to the left. Once he passes Martin, you can snap him, and that's a corner route. And look how hard it is to defend this. Like, he's going to break on this corner right there, and you're not getting pressed on that. It's really difficult to defend. Now, watch. Okay, I'm going to go. I get creative. I'm going to go zone. Okay? Now motion LaFell again. I'm going to go zone. But what's the problem here is your inside linebacker is in the flat. He doesn't get out there quick enough. He's not going to get out there and get to a point where he can defend that. And the deep zone has to go with the deep route, the deep vertical. So that one route is like an absolute backbreaker. I run this a lot, same type of concept from Gums Close in the Browns book.
Right.
But this, and then you have a nice post to Gronk. It's just really, really difficult to defend. And then off of it, I think, is the play action audible. It might not be the one. Pat's cross, PA Pat's cross.
So this is perfect.
Right.
You've got, where would you go here against zone?
I'm just going to X.
On the quick out.
Yeah, even again, I mean, right there. He doesn't get out there because of the play fake. Don't keep the play fake. You want to break out of it with the right trigger.
Okay.
So if I go cover three here, get out of it. See how it keeps him in?
The wrong button.
But the play fake keeps him in, which is just the biggest pain in the neck.
Indeed.
Huge pain in the neck. So to do that, you have to pass commit. And then if you pass commit, then you run the power O.
Right. So you should come out in the run.
Well, you can run the power. Yeah. So the power gives you the same ability to cut. I think that the power and the trap are very similar in terms of the success you can have. But those three plays, the only thing that this formation is missing is four verticals.
Right.
So get this, though.
That would be really tough.
Get this. Now, if you motion in an actual like play now game, this is one of the best sets in the game. Because audibles, motion Amendola left. Now you can get Amendola. Watch this. Amendola, quick cut. He's going to break inside.
Too soon.
See, that's why he's a 12 overall scheme in labbing. That's why he's 12.
Too soon.
Motion again. He's going to win all the time. And he cuts a quick little yard. And then on the far right, you have LaFell, who's on the corner on the quick post now. And he is going to win on the inside.
Yeah,
and with all the motion, people don't like motion.
They don't.
It's terrifying.
It's really good, actually.
Yeah, you got to use motion more. LaFell wins. He wins. That's a very good route, especially if you've got a good route running.
Especially if you're not going against Brent Grimes, who's just the nastiest. I saw some guy with Road to the Playoffs, Brent Grimes, in his lineup, and I was like,
yeah.
Don't do that. No Brent Grimes. Too slow, unfortunately. Love the guy, but too slow. This formation right here is the gun. Patriots, wing trips, gun pats, wing trips, I believe it's called. And
pats, wing trips.
You also, if you notice it too, you have somebody said wheel meshes clutch. So we initiated, hook up the brain trust with that, and then also the Pats X curl play, you have a stock out, which is pretty rare, and then you also have the table route to the halfback, which is super, super tough, and it's also the same route on curl flats, which is super, super tough. So you have some really good options from this formation. It's kind of got all the staples.
That motion, if you can mix that motion, if you can mix the one weakness is you're like pot committed to the play once you call motion, but if you can work that motion into a nice scheme, like it's really super difficult to defend.
And this right here, Madden 15.
Yeah, bread and butter.
Just, you can pretty much throw the A route for 10 yards a game.
Drag B. This makes it, this concept and this route concept here allows you to beat every defense in the game. Zone, man, blitz. It's up to you to make the right read, and it's up for your players to specifically win the matchup. But in theory, you should be able to beat every single coverage in the game with this. That's why this play is so special, and that's why we always break it down every single year.
That's why the Patriots playbook is so good. Check it out. Dudes, real quick though, I can't miss Floppy Devox sub hype. I've missed it before. Let's I will go. Not miss it this time. Sub I will hype. Not Floppy. I will not miss it this time.
I love it. Thanks, Floppy. But real quick, I want to talk why it's so good. So what makes this play so great in general is the slant out, the quick out to Chandler. That sets the tone for everything.
It's so annoying.
So here's where it wins. It wins against man to man, right? And then it wins against a cover three that does not protect the flat. That's where it wins. So, like, if I'm in this cover three here, and now, go ahead, the flat is blitzing like this, for example, and the flat's not there, and a cover three zone blitz, he wins. He's going to win. So those are two scenarios where the slant is. And you always want to throw the slant. Rule number one.
Oh, yeah.
If he's there, you throw it.
I was running the Pats book at the start of the year, I would hit this on 3rd and 10, the first drive, every game. And then when I would come out in it, they would at least have to think about how they were going to slow it down. And then you could hit another route.
But, right.
Very, very difficult.
Now, that can be... So the route progression on this play is right to left. But off of the slant out, now you went to the seam, which we can get to that. That's your last read on this play. But you want to read the slant out, and then... If the zone or the man defender, if they break it, if it's zone, they break to the slant, you throw to the underneath drag to the halfback. You're going to see that this linebacker on Chandler, he's going to go outside with him a little bit, and it's going to open up a pass lane to White underneath.
Okay.
So snap the ball, see how he goes out, and now B, too late.
Too late.
Too late. I mean, it worked, but too late.
Because you hit it, and then you want to cut.
Correct. You got to hit it quick. You got to read that defender right there in front of him.
I also see a play called wide receiver screen right here, which makes me think... I know what play this is to a halfback. Somebody was talking about this, and we're hoping to have that person on next week. That would be fantastic. Because I don't know if it might be this formation.
Maybe.
So we'll hopefully get that person on to talk about it. And
a birdie told me that he is a member of the Muttcast.
Really?
Yeah.
And since we're not in the menus at the moment,
you know it's not the goo. It's not the goo. All
right. Good stuff right there from the Patriots book.
Can we talk about the rest of the routes?
Oh, yeah.
Real quick?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, sorry about that. I know you want to get to the next thing.
No, but this is a special play. I got time.
So then off of that, they start slowing that down. They go to a user and start defending things. Then on the left side of the field, you can now do the same thing, where if it's man-to-man, you can either hit Amendola as he cuts the left. This should be a very good route runner.
You could also do the hitch thing.
You can hit him as soon as he cuts to the left, or you can hit LaFell as he cuts inside. Those are both man-beating routes. Oh, my controller. Batteries are dead. We've had battery problems for 8 years.
Yep. Still can't solve it.
Can't solve it.
I thought we had a decent run.
We did. But those two routes kill man, and they also do a very good job of doing the same thing on the left side of the field, whereas if I play a zone blitz scheme, and I bring pressure off that left edge, and I'm like, I'm going to use it as a safety, and I'm going to try and get down. You can't protect the flat. You could hot route Amendola to a flat, but the quick out will be fine.
Yeah,
he's going to go here, and he's going to just because it's so quick. It's a quick out, so yeah. It's going to serve the same purpose as that slant out. Now, if you get stock zone defense like this, again, you're going to read that one defender. Most likely, you're going to throw to LaFell because Amendola is going to pull the defense out wide, and then there's a pass lane right there to LaFell. Only a problem is the hook potentially.
Right.
Okay, so that's where that problem is. Now, your last read on this play. Is any route developing late, but it's the last read is Gronkowski. It's a seam route. So against cover one, against cover three, you got to let him clear through the underneath zones, and then you got to rely on his catch in traffic. If it's cover two, You want to let him clear down and get a one-on-one matchup with the safety. So again, clear the zones, let him get a one-on-one matchup with the safety, and then go for an aggressive catch.
Yeah, and if you really sense it being cover two, so what's good is...
Right, that's great.
So what's good is this, is if it is cover two zone, you can call this and potentially get a touchdown. And even if they snap the ball, because sometimes you don't know if it's two-man under, mm-hmm. you can then still throw to A.
Correct. If it's two-man under, you just throw... That's right. The safety that's what, valve.
There's like a... It's a built-in safety valve if you guess wrong on the coverage, where some plays don't really have that.
And this easily. Is... I'm just saying that this is the very first thing that I would do to defend this. I would go like that. I'd be right. like, oh, yeah, you're going to do that? And then if you have a burner on the outside with your halfback or your tight end, like,
right,
now it's one-on-one.
Against the LB, you're going to take a shot.
So now it's one-on-one. So the question then becomes, what do you do? How do you defend this? What's difficult... Guys, what we're showing you here, and we've said this for 2 years in a row, this is the single best play in the entire game. It's the most powerful play in the game. It has weaknesses, just like everything has a weakness. What's one of its weaknesses? Pass protection.
Yep.
When you dial up cheddar against this,
it struggles. You need a mobile quarterback, too.
Need a mobile quarterback. It's also very, very, very reliant on having the skill position players that are going to literally win every single one of these battles.
Because that's a halfback on the right.
You have to have very... Like, for Mutt, this could be a very good... offense, because you can get those players that win at every single spot. That's a weakness of it. And the probably the biggest weakness that can slow people down is your reads have to be 1,000, not 100%. They have to be 1,000% correct
yeah.
on a every single snap basis.
Right, because the first time you throw us a pick on the slant out, it's rare, but it can happen. You're going to be very, very mad at yourself.
As long as this play is in the game, it'll be the best play in the history of the game.
Yeah, it's the only one you can get a slant out, which is nice. Slant just, is stock.
Yes,
slant is stock. This, and guys, the slant out in Madden 12 was a real hot route. So every single play, you could have that slant out.
Correct.
Awesome special. Slash disaster at the same time.
Special.
So tough.
This is in the New England Patriots playbook. It's the only playbook.
It's the second to last shotgun set. What's the empty ace Patriot.
Empty ace Patriot.
Empty ace Patriot is what it's called. Shout out to E. Loranto, which I said wrong. E. Laurent Zero with the... Remember when Laurent Robinson was like a week two fantasy pickup and he was good for like... a week in Dallas, anyway.
Yeah.
The Jaguars.
You know what? I remember the same thing back in Mutt. Like, it was Mutt 13, Mutt 25 when you had Next Gen Geno Smith. He had that great game, and he was really good. And
the Next Gen was like a Schefter star.
Yeah, he was. I liked it when it was Next Generation. Yeah. I kind of like that. Next Gen, it was kind of cool. He was nasty back then.
Cool.
Life's tough. Get a helmet, I guess.
Life is tough. All right, this is a question about budget halfbacks, if you want to take a look here at Mudhead. But C.J. Spiller is who he has now, or does he go and get a more budget and affordable back? C.J. Spiller's around 95,000 coins. So I like what you're doing. You're not paying 200K for Marshall Faulk, so you're saving yourself 100K there. But you're kind of wondering, is it worth it, or should I even save 70 more K and get David Johnson, get Jeremy Langford, or get Tavon Austin, halfback out of position, who has carry issues at 80. So what are your thoughts on this, Gibbs? Check out Jeremy Langford Thanksgiving for me, and kind of we'll compare him to Campus Spiller.
I'm going to just in general, get rid of the Spiller. Like, he's good. He's a special player, but I think you get more value. The two guys are the David Johnson.
David Johnson's good. He has 95 speed. All of these guys on this list, I believe, are 94 speed or higher. That's why I have these guys selected.
Here's the deal. I personally think that Tavon Austin is the best value back in the game. Yes, I have huge concerns with carry, but it's a thing you have to monitor. I would say he's worth the risk. Try him out. He's going for 20K. That's very affordable. Play with him. I think his raw stats make him so special. Not only as just a pure runner, but as a pass receiver out of the backfield with four verticals. He's got good catch in traffic, good route running, good spectacular catch. I think he's a very rare special player to have in Mutt. I would definitely try him out. I would monitor the carry situation, and if he starts having problems, then you have to look elsewhere. But it's an absolute must look at halfback. Okay. That's my recommendation.
The other thing is, look at the Todd Gurley Football Outsiders. He's really, really good. Some people are saying go up to the Freeze Devontae Freeman, who's super, super expensive. I do like the Freeze Freeman. I like his blend of ratings across the board. He's kind of got that McKinnon where he's got the speed and the agility. But he's actually got the rich man stats too, like the ball carrier vision and everything, because he had such a good season. So I like the Freeman, but I don't have anything against Campus Spiller, the Spiller.
I do. It's his catching traffic and his route running.
But what's his route running?
I'll tell you in a second.
Is it, how bad is it? Because that's be the real question. I mean, everything could be better, but right. He kind of does a little bit of everything.
He's very good. He's very good. But if we're talking dollars here and he was going for the 90K, then...
it's not too bad.
His route running 75. His catch traffic 77.
Like, is he better than signature Reggie Bush for the price? 67K?
Oh, yeah.
He's down to 67K on Xbox
One. See, that's a better price. Now,
what's his carry? Is he
90? 90 carry. That's
very That's a good. Threshold I like to see. CJ.
That's a threshold you want to be at. The carries on the other guys on Lamar Miller, Team of the Week, David Johnson, Team of the Week, and Todd Gurley, Outsiders. Carries 93, 90, 95.
Yeah, those guys are really good, but I don't think they can catch either.
None of them can route run.
Yeah.
None of them can really catch in traffic. Yeah, I mean, okay, for now, 67K, I would say that CJ Spiller is now quickly turning into the best value back.
Yeah, I mean, Tavon Austin is going to get you the budget, but the reason he's budget is the carry. That's who I would go to next. I would check the Langford Thanksgiving, see if he matches
Here's
up.
Special Spiller, 97 juke move.
Yeah.
That's special. That's special talents.
It's nice.
Great player.
And if you can, go up to the Folk as you get better route running, better catch. If you're going to use him as a pass catcher, so that's what's up. All right, next question in the mailbag. What is the best way to utilize trucking in the game, specifically for Bo Jackson? So if you were going to try and truck players, what would you want to do?
One-on-one on the edge. One-on-one on the edge.
Yeah?
That's where I think.
So you don't like to do it up the middle? Like, you don't like to run
that? I would rather double juke in the middle. I know that sounds backwards, but if I'm going to... I would never personally use a trucking back, in my opinion. I always go speed, agility, acceleration, juke. I mean, for the past couple of years, at least. I really think you got to go on the outside. You go truck because you get a one-on-one. Like right there, you get a one-on-one if you had him. And then you want to try and bulldoze him. There's not as many defenders near you.
Right.
My problem is if you truck in the middle of the field, you're just going to get tackled somewhere else. Like,
right.
That's my problem with it.
Yeah, and my issue with the truck is that the window is very, very small. So watch me hit the right trigger there. And I timed it pretty well right there. I still didn't break the tackle. But if I hit it just a hair early... he's going to complete his whole truck animation where he, and then you're not getting the power. So
you can always left trigger it too. Like you can always
make it precision. Yeah. I know, it's still pretty quick though. And it used to kind of be longer. Like you could almost hold it.
Right.
That wasn't bad. You got a couple extra yards. But if you are going to use a trucking back, you should just be getting some broken tackles if you run up the middle and hopefully falling forward. That's more the key to trucking backs is falling forward and making every 4 yard carry a 6 yard carry. Whereas an elusive back, you got to make a 2 yard carry with a double juke, a 19 yard carry.
Right.
Up the middle.
Well, right where I like it right there is you use it on the outside because you're one on one and there's not as many people to chase you down from behind. Like, right, like I don't like it there because you're inside, there's safety there. If you take that run outside of the receiver, I like it more. Right there, there's no one out near you.
Right.
You use it there, hopefully you spring that.
Right.
That's where I think you can use it. And left trigger it.
And you do win. I got trucked by Terrell Davis.
Yep, here it is.
I think it was Brian Dawkins. I mean, I almost had to retire the item. That's how badly he got smushed into the turf. So there is times for it. Maybe Seagrell's that good on the sticks.
Seagrell.
But I still think overall you're going to break more tackles as an elusive back. Not necessarily dollar for dollar broken tackles like... I had a tackler had his hand on me and I physically broke the tackle. You're probably going to still break more trucking. But there's so many little things an elusive back lets you do to not even get tackled.
Mm-hmm.
Like Andre Williams for the Giants gets tackled more often than any other back because he just runs at the tackler and tries to... Every tackle he breaks, he is initiating the contact. Where like LeSean McCoy might only have one guy touch him on a play... But he might have made a guy hesitate, made another guy contain his lane, and he might have broken four tackles on a run, but not actually had a guy touch his jersey. Mental pretzel. That's kind of what you got to think about.
Seti said he'll sub if I dance. What dance do I have to do?
Is he making us do it again?
Seti said I'll dance. Real quick, though, I want to give a shout to Killer Cam Dog. He said, what's up, guys? Love the stream. Love you, Killer Cam Dog. But to the question at hand here, Seti, he'll sub if we dance.
All right. Radville wants to know, do you have any man beaters out of the Vikings playbook? So, Radville, we did have a scheme in the Brain Trust from the Gun Empty Bunch that beat Mano's Bunch Divide. The motion on the wheel doesn't work quite as well, so it's not quite as dynamic.
You can show it here.
Yes.
Tight doubles on.
Gun tight doubles on.
Yeah, wide receiver cross. This is somewhat similar to it. Just it's stock. What you're looking for is a wheel pattern like this. This is a part of it. It's a gun empty bunch that plays called Divide Wheel. And the route on the left will be very similar to the LaFell route. As soon as he cuts up field, you need a specific player. You gotta have route running. Yeah, so he cuts up here, and then when he cuts there, he wins. I know it's a tight throw, but it's because of the route running situation. So you need a guy with a special rating to help you win that route. And then you have other crossing patterns that are super helpful on that pattern, too.
Yes, and the Vikings also have, I think they have Gun Ace Twins, 99% sure they do. And Gun Ace Twins is a great formation for beating those coverages. Say, similar to Gun Ace is Gun Ace Twins. We showed earlier in the show to play Hitch Corners. So obviously, Gun Ace Twins will be more like this. You'd have the play posts, and then you'd have the play smash. So you'd still have the tight end on the corners. You would have... Ooh, this is kind of nice, because then you could do Amendola on a hitch.
Quick drag. And a drag
and
to LaFell.
And then drag to the outside.
To LaFell.
So I would do something like this, and then I'd like to have the table route to Bolden, the little halfback out to the right side. So this would be like Gun Ace Twins. I'll learn the timing. You don't want to have... There it is.
Danny Amendola fumble.
So, Gun Ace Twins, check it out. The play post, the play smash. Two plays that can beat man. Use a drag as one of your ways to beat it. And then you have a corner. You got a halfback on the table.
Should we dance for Seti?
Did he sub?
He's asking that we had to dance first.
No.
By the way, guys, if you're liking the show, if you like what you're seeing here, we've been showing up for 7 years now.
Yeah.
Showing up for 7 years. Follow the channel. This is not our first time at the rodeo. Follow the channel if you like what we're doing here. We show up and do this for the past 7 years because you guys keep showing up.
Every Wednesday night.
When you guys stop showing up, we're going to stop, I guess.
Yeah, I think that's the deal. I'm going to check my Twitter real quick for questions and see if we have any good ones. Seagarel is using the 245 double A gap. He likes the nickel dog Meg. Would you do any adjustments with that defense? Have you found luck with that defense? What are your thoughts?
I've seen a little bit of it. I just think I tend to not love formations for blitzing purposes when you stack a ton of guys in the A gap area. I like more edge. Because I feel like you're very vulnerable to tosses at that point as well. So that's just my general feeling of it. I haven't personally used that formation very much this year. I did lap in the beginning of the year. I didn't find it very effective. It's going to be good for stopping runs up the middle. But in terms of pressure, in terms of overall scheme, I would avoid it. Specifically because if you want to play man-to-man and you go against a spread set, you're going to be vulnerable because you got guys stacked in the gaps.
What are the best run plays against quarters and dime?
Quarters and... I'm assuming he's talking about like DB strike one.
Yeah.
I would probably just tell you inside zones or like I would say even more simple than that, like I form normal halfback dive.
So the reason the quarters is good is because it locks down the edges. So if you try and run inside zone and then go out, it looks like it's going to be there, but then it gets clamped. You have to keep it in the middle, and I know that they're using it in there and it's tough and you only get 2 yards and you feel like you should be getting 8, but you can break big runs up the middle with that. Talk about the double juke we hit on the safety. You've got to go and make that something you can get to. Otherwise, you're going to struggle to beat it. You can also run I-form sets that have a lead blocker and go right up the middle. It like makes the game very remedial because you got to go back to these elementary sets. But it does end up working for you. Shout out to the chat. Devo Slice in the building. Gibbs is about to play Ultimate Team with Ndamukong Suh at kicker in the game of the week. It is time. We're going to talk real quick about the Madden Challenge. We got the bracket review. Gibbs, did you see any matchups, any killers on there that you're excited to watch play this week?
Yeah, I mean, we're just waiting for the final rankings to come out. I know they're making some adjustments, some audits to the leaderboard. We talked to the commish. So really, before we can jump forward and get excited about those things, you got to see those final rankings after the audits. But, you know, I'm excited that you see guys like M, and we know M Stack's in the tournament.
That's M Stack 42 made Madden the tournament.
Madden Tips own, right? Yeah, we are excited. Shout out if M Stack's in here, everyone. Go in the Madden Secret Society and get excited about M-Stack. He's in the tournament, so that's really exciting.
And one other thing to look out for this weekend is players playing their Madden Challenge games. If you guys can support them, that's super helpful to the community. This is going to be a big tournament situation. It's one of our first years back as a tournament community. You know, we haven't had a big event since Madden 13, and we want this thing to keep growing. And it's been really good. You've had the big guys who everybody wants to see play, you know, you've seen the problems play, but these guys earn their way in and they're about to compete. They're about to play a 64 man tournament on each console. So they earn their way in through draft champions ranked. They're going to be in that top 64, three games to get a chance to go to California to play each other. There's some guys in there I've been seeing on the leaderboard for a long time. Snap, Onik, Skimbo, Stevie J, I believe. M-Stack's been grinding. Both Madden Daily guys.
Dudes have been grinding. Out here.
There's a lot of guys. Rose Bowl's on there. I can't believe Secret, after the Secret, rough man. Performance in his first time back, made it in. Pretty crazy. All these guys are going to have a shot, and it's going to be interesting to see who makes it in. So, all
right, boys. Here's my squad. I'm going to play out of position Poe at quarterback. Here's my question. Right now I have him as my punter.
And if you guys have your picks for Madden Challenge and any things you're excited about, let us know in the chat. I just refreshed the chat. So hit me up and let me know what Madden Challenge players you're excited for.
I have Sue as my punter. I'll still be able to use him as quarterback, correct?
Yeah, I don't know if you have to. Yeah, you can just submit, right?
Yeah, and just so you guys know, I'm going to be playing with him, and I'm going to be playing on all Madden 1. I'm 9-0 right now, so this
you're 9-0.
It's a playoff game.
This is a playoff.
Oh, it's for a first round bye.
Do you want to talk about your lineup real quick?
Sure. So this defense is specifically set up for nickel 3-5 odd. I think the most important position here for the whole scheme is this right outside linebacker. Doesn't need to be this Derek Brooks, definitely not. But what you need here is a guy that is not a Lawrence Taylor. It needs to be a guy that is like great zone coverage, good man coverage, good speed. And that's what this Brooks does. We talked about him on the Mudcast. He does everything. 91 speed. He's got great coverage ability. Brooks brings a lot to the table. And that's where you also see me play Marshall and Navarro Bowman in the middle of the field. Both guys can play coverage. Both guys are super effective when it comes to playing man-to-man coverage or zone. Then on the right side, which is my left line outside linebacker, plays on the right side of the field. When I go to 3-4, I want a guy with block shit on the edge there. So that's where Zach Thomas comes into play. If Thomas gets tired, McPhee comes in. And of course, I have my user, Taylor Mays. My backup coverage guys are Tom Davis, Kiko Alonso, and Lavonte David. I sub in Sean Taylor and Ronnie Lott, also Nitrane Lane. If I go to a 3-4 aggressive style defense, if I'm trying to stop the run, and I'll put Taylor and Lott. Actually, I'll probably take out Taylor and put in Lane and Lott and put them at corner, sub them in, and I play cover two. So then I have Lane, Lott, Dawkins. That's what I do. I sub out Ed Reed and put Ronnie Lott there, and then Taylor and Nitrane Lane at corner. And I have all that hit power on the field, aggressive style defense. Offensively, I go with Bo for only strictly running situations. And I got Barry, Falk for the double guys in the backfield, guns but close. Tavon Austin, special player. I'm testing out the Cunningham right now.
Not missing throws.
I love the Vic, but Vic awesome. Does miss throws. That's my problem, I guess.
Yeah.
But I'm testing out the Cunningham. Dontaire Poe's great. Love the Donald Penn here at tight end. Jerry Rice, haven't used too many games with him.
He's fire.
But overall, this is the squad. The kill squad, as the goo would say.
The goo would call this a kill squad.
This is a good team. No? You would say that, right?
It's very good. Let's see if you can win with Ndamukong Suh is your QB.
No, you didn't change, like, you didn't change my stuff, correct? Like, you didn't change.
I wouldn't touch anything, bro.
You sure?
Promise.
Let me just make sure.
Mays versus Atwater at linebacker. So there's a out of position Taylor Mays and there's out of position Steve Atwater. Do you have an opinion?
I haven't tried the Atwater.
He tackled me in the Guru game. He seems pretty good.
I haven't tried him yet, so yeah. I've used the Mays. I haven't been super excited about the Mays.
You kind of got to use the Mays,
right? You can't let him just play. So the other big news here. This is going for my 200th win.
All right.
And I'm playing with Sue.
200th win in Ndamukong Suh. 10-0 season.
What do you do?
Let's go.
Do it.
Can we get some guys to tweet this for us?
Yeah. Let's put a link in the chat.
Let's do it. I'm going to share this bad boy.
We'll take the wind.
We'll take the wind.
Benhove, this is a good team.
Benhove just re-subbed.
He did?
Yeah. Shout out.
Dang.
Going for his 200th.
All right, guys. In the chat, let me know. Type 1 if you think I'm going to win with Ndamukong Suh as my quarterback. Type 2 if you think I'm going to lose with Ndamukong Suh as my quarterback. Is there any stipulation here where I can't use, I can sub out Suh? Or do I have to use him the entire game?
It's up to the chat.
Okay. They think I can win with the Suh. I don't even know how to dab. How do you dab? They're asking for me to dab. It's like, and then you go and dab on him, and dab on him, and dab on him. And you run, you fake run, and then you dab on him.
That run move that everyone's doing.
Like, dot 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 dab on him, dab on him. There you go. I dabbed a couple times. Alright, Suh's committed. Dang, you Suh. I'm playing Sappy Lithium.
Sappy. Not gonna like that.
I gotta just score on defense, is what I think. Or score on my special teams, because my special teams are so special. Alright, Farls. Sappy Lithium, here we go. What if I just score first play, right here?
That would help.
Come on, Neon. Neon.
He might have.
Needed it.
Couldn't get there. I'm going to narrate this bad boy for needed the fans. It. I'm going to send you guys this tweet if you would be so kind.
There he is. Ndamukong Suh at quarterback. I'm gonna try this offense with him, just so you know. Go try him. All right. Uh-oh. No way. Is he going to give it to me first play?
Are you going to run it?
No.
All right, so SGibs, Suh, he's gonna Pat, quarterback. Gibbs gonna run the Pats drag, X drag trail.
Come on, give it to me, doctor.
He's going deep. He ran cover three, hit the cover three throw. I will say that play mashes cover three.
Dance, dance, dance. I'm out here doing the dance.
If you had a little more throw power, that's a touchdown.
That was dot eponymous Suh. What are his stats, by the way? Do we know?
We do not know. We're not sure what Suh is. I'll look him up. So he's a punter playing quarterback.
I can't audible.
Cannot audible. That's not good.
Forgot I can't audible.
All right, so punter Suh for Gibbs.
Dot.
Dot eponymous. This is the next Drew Butler.
Too strong out here.
And this is his 82 kicker. He's got 97 kick power. Throw power.
Can I use? I don't think I can get Suh here and at
Wildcat. Well, then you can't use Wildcat.
That's not true. I'm not gonna pass. This is a running. It's a running set.
Whatever you gotta do. He has Ndamukong Suh.
Wait. Timeout.
What? Six. His throw short is 6. His throw medium is 6. His throw deep is 6.
I got away.
His throw on the run is 6.
I got away. I got him
his
in.
His play action is 6. His throw power is 28.
Not bad. It could be way worse.
I've never seen lower than 6.
I got him in. I got him in the cat. I got him in at the cat, baby. All right,
Ndamukong Suh running the Wildcat. Prince TYR and Dot Yukong Suh. They say you can use Wildcat. That's what's up.
Wait, I can.
Yeah.
I don't have to use them.
Yeah, you should use them, though.
To make things fun?
Yeah, just to humor us. Because you're going to pitch it, and it's going to be awesome. Robbius says, no way you win without audibling. All right, Robbius, watch out.
Ndamukong Suh, baby. Arf, arf, arf. Arf. Be a big truck.
If you get Poe and Sue in there, that's going to be some serious stuff.
Oh, yeah. Here's, you know, I got to get Phil Lodeho, and I got to get, watch. I get Poe.
Poe boy?
I get
Donald Penmore.
No.
You didn't bring him.
I got him. Oh, wait. I got to pop him out.
Any updates to the 3-3-5 odd that you would... You pretty much is all in there, right? You call man,
yeah.
Call zone, flip it, send it.
Just like put your thing down.
There's a couple of adjustments, but that's kind of a game-specific thing. There is primetime KCS with the sub hype. I feel honored. He didn't want to be one undone by Ben Hove. Ndamukong Suh on the Wildcat, fakes the handoff, pitches it out to Barry Sanders, who gets to the edge and goes in for the touchdown.
Make a little Sue. Get down tonight.
So Ndamukong Suh goes deep on the first play of the game with his 6 deep accuracy rating, hits a long cover 3 shot, then hits a short drag over the middle, then runs the Wildcat for a couple plays, pitches it out to Barry. Gibbs gets in, 4 plays, 63 yards, can audible, not a problem?
Not a problem.
What would tips do you have out there for the kids?
Just, you know, you got to read the defense and take what they give you.
That's how you live your life.
And then you Gibbs kick it and you get a fumble.
Robbius thinks you have no chance of winning this game, but little does he know.
We'll see. Bang! Oh, that was Ronnie Lott.
Ronnie Lott. That return's good for about 6. Ben Hove, primetime KCS refusing to be outdone by.
Oh, he's
Ben
going.
Hove. This guy's got a rivalry. All right, Gibbs' opponent here going with 5 wide. And Gibbs is going to come out in the 3-3-5 odd, which we talked about. He's going to go wide receiver screen. He's going to have to get out there and use her, and he makes a nice tackle with the Ed Reed. There was a question in the chat that we somehow missed that said, is Ed Reed worth 1.9 million points? And the answer to that question is no, he's not worth 1.9 million. He was when he first came out, but there's been a ton of dudes that have come out at strong safety. He is the best option, but for 1.9 million... No, I can't say that he is, especially because he only has 94 zone coverage, which you've now got Earl Thomas with 96. I know he's free safety, but you also could just put a 98 zone coverage guy in there. That is the play we just showed.
It's not the play.
That wasn't a slant out? False alarm. He goes across the middle on 4th and 3 to the tight end, Tyler Eifert. Great item. Peyton Manning. This guy's got a little bit of a Broncos squad. I think he has a Demarius in the lineup. He's got Amari Cooper, who you should absolutely have on your lineup. And play action, Peyton Manning throws into triple coverage, and Deion Sanders breaks it up. That was Amari Cooper. I've mentioned how good he is and that you get him for doing your solos, your newest solo challenges, the quick ones. But that doesn't mean you should throw to him in triple coverage. Very patient throw right there. Good route by that guy. A good read across the middle. That might have been Steve Smith. Who knows who that is? Could be Doug Baldwin, who's also a very good budget 89. He's got C.J. Anderson at halfback, probably team of the week. This guy's running a Broncos scheme, running with auto motion and play action and throwing.
Oh,
to the tight end
I was underneath that.
And Night Train Lane lurked it.
So under that.
Is that a user?
I didn't get the user, but I was so under that. Just see. He's quitting. That's
is
a big
he gonna quit? Pepper me Pepper, shout out for following the channel. And Gibbs gets his 10th win of the season. Too easy. Ndamukong Suh, 2-for-2 passing.
Touchdown.
I mean, you gotta run it back.
That's how it's done.
Are you willing to put a playoff game on the line?
Of course I am. Of course I am.
Confidence.
Yeah.
Confidence. Give the fans what they want.
Yeah.
Sell J.J. Watt for Za'Darius Smith and take the coins. No, I wouldn't do that, Trev, unless you need the coins. Za'Darius Smith, very, very good. You should have one. He should be in your lineup. But the J.J. Watt, a little bit better. Everyone here that's watching should have a Za'Darius Smith. Everyone here that's watching should have
Good thing about Sue, great awareness.
How can he only have six? Like, most guys have 12. Most guys, like, what does Brad Wing have? 25. Like, give me 25. Don't give me six.
Is he the new Dot Butler? But I mean, look at that awareness. He's got more awareness than Mike Vick.
So he's wicked smart. He's wicked aware.
All right, let's go.
Glad. Who quits? Honestly, who quits? We also need to get some emotes in our lives. If you guys have ideas for emotes, shout out to W Pool for hooking us up with the subtrain emote, which I find awesome. We're going to see if we can get him to make us a couple more, but we want to come up with some. I might get one of me biting my shirt. I mean, depends what we really need. You guys can let me know. If you guys want to RT this tweet,
RT, we'll share. RT.
That will be hot. Primetime KCS has those emotes now, and he's digging it. The shirt bite emote might need to be made for real.
The shirt bite emote?
Could be pretty good. Also, what else can we do? I have ideas. I got to remember to write them down. We'll do a straw poll.
Have we pulled a thing lately?
A popsicle stick?
Yeah.
Have not. We're going to have to come up with some giveaways. I've got, I think, the biggest giveaway of the season coming up around the Super Bowl. So if you're not subbed this month, the Super Bowl's within 1 month.
Mm-hmm.
I think you're going to want to consider subbing for the Super Bowl.
Why? What's happening? What are you doing? What are your...
Got a giveaway coming up for the subs.
What are your plans?
It's going to hurt me more than it's going to hurt you.
What's your giveaway? You're giving away your best guy ever?
It's not a guy. It's not a mud item. It's just an item. I'm giving away an item.
Like a real item.
Like a real
physical item. Is it that helmet?
It's better than that helmet.
Is it your computer?
Hello, everybody. No. Larry Ridley
welcoming you to. What are you giving away? You giving away my dog?
It's like that helmet, but it's a better helmet.
Oh. Who is it?
Maybe it's not a helmet at all.
Alright, I'm playing JVS 810.
I feel like JVS is good, but I don't know. I feel like every player I play is good.
Is he in the playoffs? Playoffs! Are you gonna give away my whole team?
That would be awesome.
No, wouldn't it?
That would not be awesome. All right, Deion Sanders for SGibs with the return. Double juice. Is Deion a good kick return for you?
Love him.
I already gave away my car to the Kidney Foundation. Otherwise, that could be up for grabs.
Did you really do that?
Yeah.
That was nice.
It was. They never mailed me the paperwork, so I'm kind of mad at them. But, you know. Cal Persh has 1.6 million coins.
Uh-oh, here it is again. Let's go.
Cal, I need to know your lineup. I need to know who you have, what you like to do. Email
one
me,
time for me.
Farrells at MaddenTips.
One time for me, fellas, and the boys at home. Hold the block. Hold blocks. I threw the wrong thing.
Good. You had a chance to check down to RB.
I messed it up.
What happened?
I messed it up. I swear he hot-routed the right guy.
Korsma's in the building. Korsma, one of my favorite streamers from across the pond. Shout out to Jerry Ricecake for the sub hype. Jerry, check your Twitch messages tonight after
the
show.
Here we go. Sue's going to do it this time. He's going to dot him up. He's going to dot a potamus him up. Jerry.
All right, here we go. To Jerry Ricecake, follow the stream. We've got QB Sneak D. We've got 335 odd defensive scheme. We have M-Stacks, 6 videos here for the Titans. There's a Wildcat update in there. Check that out tonight.
He doesn't have a ton of throw power, I'll tell you that.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one.
Tough not being able to audible. I'll tell you what, that's the most difficult part.
First down at the
but when you just have dots, like...
Ew. He's mad at himself.
You should hang your head in disgust, Ndamukong. God! Alright, he's in man again. I know he's in man. I need Ndamukong to throw a dot here.
Let's see what happens. Drags underneath, can't hit the throw, and SGIF now 1-for-4 with boy name Sue. Tough.
Very tough.
He was hitting throws earlier, now he's not hitting them
all. Now he's laying down for the bread.
Wolfman sub. Whoa. That is... You know you've made it when Wolfman subs to your channel.
Okay, alright, come on. Come on,
Barron is a bit of an upgrade. He's kind of like a baby Sean Taylor. He does certain things well. He does, like, not certain things well. You got to make sure you know what he does and what he can't do. Gibbs. Sue with the overthrows. Gibbs is going to blame it on Sue. I'm also going to blame it on Sue because his receivers were pretty open and he wasn't trying to make two advanced throws. He's going to go for it on 4th and 10. Gibbs is going to go for it on 4th and 10. This is a tilt move.
No, it's not.
He's like, Sue can't throw 4 bad passes in a row, only 3. And let's see if he can make a read. I think Gibbs thinks his opponent is playing elementary coverage and that he can get a guy open if he tries his hardest. Mean Joe Green block shed up the middle. Sue forced to throw away.
Big Suey. Big Suey.
Big Suey.
Hey, listen, that's what happened when you play with a quarterback. Your quarterback's Ndamukong Suh.
You can sue it.
Sue can do it.
Shout out to Rich Havoc. Not only did he sub to the channel, but he also followed the channel. So, Rich, you'll get notified when we go live. Remember, we do this every Wednesday night, 8 o'clock. Playoff games this weekend. Interested to know your guys' thoughts. That's the exact run defense we talked about earlier in the show.
Whoa.
So,
Bojangles. I need to fight. Can I sit where you're sitting? Like, I feel terrible about where I'm sitting.
Can you switch? Me and you?
Yeah. I just feel better.
Need some soda water?
I could use some soda water.
Coming up, second down. Is this yours?
Let's go. And people all over the world.
Pressure comes in from the right.
No.
Not thirsty right now. That's a first. I've never fed SGibs live on stream before.
Thank you, coach.
That worked out. That could have been a lot worse. All right, here we go. Third and 2. His opponent in field goal range with Gibbs going for it. And let's see. He's in man coverage. I think he might run, but we'll have to see. He does indeed run.
See, I wanted to make him cut back. I had pressure off that right edge. I felt good about that. That's all right.
That works. We have, we do have the Elite controller. It's pretty nice. It's pretty nice. The sticks I'm still getting kind of used to, but, you know, something you got to test out.
I have more faith in Sue this drive.
Shira has told me to use the paddles on the back to get extra hit sticks, I believe, and ball hawk, but I haven't done that yet. So, if you have excellent user skills, does it matter the play you call? Yes, it does matter, Frank. What you want to use those user skills to do is to allow you to call a more risky defense. So if you can cover 2 routes, well, now you don't need 2 defenders. You just need 1 defender. You could blitz the other one or drop him somewhere else and then allow you to...
We got Poe in the game, we got Sue in the game, and Donald Penn in the game.
So you're going big dogs.
Big dogs. Let the big dogs eat. Right now he's like, what? Wildcat.
What? And he's like, yeah, he's going to run out.
And next thing you know, it's Sue. It's Pig Suey.
Sue Purple. First down at the 17. Here we go. Oh, it was there. Double juke. Almost too quick on the double juke. Barry, too strong. I haven't tried the longer sticks on the Elite controller yet. I haven't really done much more than just kind of use it as a straight-up paddle, but, you know.
Because I'm going to make them dance, bump, 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 bump.
All right, Gibb in the white Patriots uniforms.
Wildcat.
Ndamukong Suh, Poe.
Wildcat, you make everything.
Second and 4, picks up 3 yards on the blast right. If you guys are watching this and you're not subbed, you can actually get a little look at what we do in the Wildcat. We break it down.
Look what's up with his username. Ban him. What a clown. Wildcat.
When you get the trolls, you know you made it. Oh, wow. That was a nice spin. Do you think the spin rating increases the spin of the speed, the range of the spin, or the range, the speed of the spin? Like, what would
speed.
It,
speed. Speed, yeah. Faster? It's tighter, quicker.
Alright.
Watch this. He's gonna get so angry.
Jerry Rice Cake loves the dancing. That's how we got the song.
Wow, dang. You make everything.
Tony.
Ruin. Wildcat.
World.
You make everything.
Start a subtrain.
Ruin. Wildcat. You make everything.
Soupy.
Groovy. Bow, bow. Bow, 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 bow.
To Poe?
Sue to Poe.
Wow.
Sue to Poe.
Sue
to Poe. Sue to Poe. Sue to Poe. Ha ha. Wildcat. Bow, bow. You make it. And Doc and Sue. Look at Sue. He's being a beast out on the field.
Ndamukong tearing it up. And Gonzalez. Shout out to Shira in the chat. He's actually here. I just mentioned him. He has the setups for the Elite controller. I have to still take the action that he mentioned, but if you have questions, you can message him. All right, here we go. Sue pitches it out to Barry. That's a foul, Marino, and Barry can't jump on it. And the dancing stops.
Okay.
Gibbs. And Ronnie Lott recovers the fumble. He's already down 3-0. Sue having a bad game passing. Couldn't even pitch right there. And now Gibbs is going to need to lock up on defense. His opponent has a Bo Jackson. His opponent has a nasty squad. That was...
Pick it.
What was that?
Yeah,
your guy got in, but then the PA got picked up.
Dang.
Guys, Za'Darius Smith, really, really good. We also have, what else is there? This is a playoff game for Gibbs, so this is a lot on the line. He's 10-0, so a lot of coins.
Good route. That's a good route.
Is that
Vernon Davis? It was just a straight streak. That was pretty good.
So Vernon Davis... for Gibbs' opponent right there. Wow. Vernon Davis. I think that's his new flashback. That might not even be Vernon Davis. But Vernon Davis did get a new flashback, which is actually pretty good.
Bojangles.
Bo was about to do that double tackle spin out break. But it takes too long. But it's still awesome. Let's see. Have some patience. Stay with it. Hey, man, we'll take the followers or we can get them.
Yeah.
JK. Halfback Cam Newton's out there. There's a lot of items. I haven't thought of anything to do with the halfback cam, but aside from halfback pass, but that's just not really a full scheme.
I don't think this controller is getting adjustments in.
The stick's a little different, I think. I don't know. Third and four. Big third and four. Needs a stop. Needs a slowdown. He's got Lorenzo Neal in the game. Hines Ward. This is looks like a rushing lineup. We'll have to see what he does. Third down and four. Sack lunch sandwich.
Come on, he gets to throw off,
though. We'll see if this opponent makes it 6-0. He is going to. Smart move since Gibbs is playing with Ndamukong Suh at kicker. And Gibbs finally does not have he's not outmatching this guy lineup to lineup. This guy's got a really, really good lineup, JDS.
What's not happening is, like, the secondary, like, line adjustment's not occurring.
I see.
I'm out. Now I'm so out on the Elite controller now, it's ridiculous.
I don't know. Deion Sanders takes it back to the 25. And Ndamukong Suh here is going to trot out and play.
Listen, we keep things simple here, right? We run a Wildcat scheme with Ndamukong Suh. We put the ball in his hand on the first drive in four passes in a row.
It's like Novocaine. Just give it time. Always works. Shout out to Kalia in the chat. I've been noticing you may have been here a lot. Thanks for coming around. Pitch was there.
What's up, Sue?
That was Marshall. Falk. I think. It said Marshall Falk 0-for-1 passing. I don't know why that would be.
He's got such low throw accuracy, he can't even pitch the ball. Is this true?
Right? It gave him.
This is true?
Okay. Third and passing. Let's see what he does here on 3rd and 8.
Listen, I just got to win this game by locking up on defense or something.
Honest gamer, Brandon Marshall, 93, is excellent if you're playing zone coverage in the middle. Really, really good with that rating. A little slower, maybe not the best run guy, but still superior zone coverage. Make some plays. Vic Beasley, I'm not Vic in
Beasley.
On.
Vic Beasley.
But I could see how you could use him. Here's the quick toss. There it is. Oh, a cut block from Poe, and that is why you get a Barry Sanders. Takes it over midfield right there. Against the cover four. Minute 53 left.
You do everything. Groove.
What's up?
Oh, that's what I needed. I needed that. I needed him to take the guy off the line, and then Poe, dog. You big truck.
Three carries for 3 yards for Ndamukong Suh, quarterback.
Be a big truck.
Gibbs locked in a tight battle here.
Rockets in the house.
What's up, Rockets Live? Young Dower, what I try and do is also stream on Mondays at some point for the Team of the Weeks. I probably won't do that now that the Team of the Weeks, the regular season's over. I don't know what the plan is, but if there's new items, like if there's a chunk of new items, I'll try and stream. If like today there was two flashbacks or yesterday. So I won't stream for two flashbacks unless they're super notable, but Wow, Barry's not good at recovering fumbles either.
Okay, we're going to have to find a new strata guy. We're going to have to find a new strata guy.
This guy gets ball after half, so you really need a stop here. Really need a stop here. 6-0, because you're not going to put up points in a hurry with this roster.
No.
Shout out to DReed74 with the sub hype, man. I appreciate that, DReed. Sorry, I almost missed that for you. You the man. All right, Vic going across the middle, short throw. Gibbs going to take a timeout.
You think? Just let him know that.
Just can't let him score.
Just let him know that gastric bypass is coming after him.
Gassing it. Yeah, DJ, I still break down teams if you email me. A couple notes on your squad. I can give you some recommendations. Give me targeted recommendations. I have made that budget sheet for everybody.
He's going to play action. Helps no?
With the lineups. That's a Bo Jackson. Broken tackle.
See, that's where Bo is good in these sets because he gets an extra oomph.
Gets a couple free broken ones for show. If you guys have favorites in the Madden Challenge, let us know. If you guys are like friends with anybody and you know they're going to be playing their games or you want to see them compete or you think somebody's good that we're overlooking.
I tried to bypass it the other way.
Suh got pushed back on defense there. He must be tired from playing offense. The nose tackle got blown up there.
Different.
Same guy, though. Is Poe better than Neal at fullback? I take Neal. Soul Clap made it to a real stream. He's a YouTube guy on youtube.com/ZFarls.
That's Ball.
But he is joining the party tonight. Remember, go over to youtube.com/ZFarls for
one
more.
Clap this time.
Follow that channel. But yeah, watch live on twitch.tv/tips.
Watch this. I want to try and make him think.
You in two, man?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a pick by Night Train Lane, and that is a pick six.
Doing the dance.
And that's big right there. That's the difference between... I know drags don't really use route running, but that Vernon Davis, I think, has like 74 route running. Do you think that could be...
That's the exact problem. You need route running. It's not just a speed.
He has 92 speed.
Right, it's not just a speed. Speed's going to give you the initial like break. But then the big separation is on the cut, and you're not going to get that with just speed, no route running. You got to have both.
That's a negative on feedback for the Davis. Kick. He ran a streak well, but he just got a tackle. You got Pernell McPhee.
That's a great little.
That's Calvin. Calvin on that. That was man-to-man. SGibs fighting.
Fight.
Huge.
Fight.
Play.
I do have a Madden New Year's Eve resolution. It's to work more nickel 3-3-5 wide.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm going to lab it and put more.
Okay. Guys are going to watch M-Stack. Let's see. Anybody else watching? I mean, you guys got Serious Mo is Cal Cruel's neighbor. 77 route running.
That was a lot of bad on me. I really didn't expect what he was running there. Like, Hail Mary Trio. That's bad. That's bad on me all around. I shouldn't have been in the defense I was in at all. That was terrible defense. It's terrible defense. Terrible defense. What?
Clock management, 13. Got a chance to return this one. Because there's only 13 seconds left in the half. I know, who calls Hail Mary?
Is that what you think?
Apparently this guy, but I don't know. That was strange.
Is that what you think about me?
I'm confused what happened. That was weird.
Is that what you think?
Let's see if he can bust one here. 3 seconds left. Ndamukong Suh can't afford a turnover.
Right.
Takes it. Yeah, no, you just gotta lock up. You've locked up. That was weird. The eventual tourney will be streamed, yes, on the twitch.tv/EA Sports channel. Shout out to Thomas G. Yeah, the Vernon Davis has really good strength. His speed strength combo is pretty elite.
Scuds is here?
Scuds sub hype.
Scuddies?
Yeah.
Welcome back, Scuds.
But a blunder at the end of the half there.
I played cover three zone and I just
shaded underneath.
Terrible clock management. I don't know.
What happened?
Bad clock management for us.
I'll try and get the full story after the game, boys. 13-7. Bo Jackson off tackle.
Derek Brooks
comes in, makes the play. Brooks seems to react really well to outside runs. If he's on the line, he can get pushed back, but I do notice he breaks in if he's out far enough against like tosses, similar to how kind of Clay Matthews used to do, which was good. The tournament will, like I said, eventually be streamed on Twitch. Press coverage to the outside. All right, 2nd and 14 after a nice first down stop. Gibbs user in Taylor Mays, who's known to have some pop in his bat, and Bo Jackson picks up.
Yeah, he's running first.
Some carries. Yeah, this guy's gonna run the rock if he can. And 3rd and 4.
I mean, when you got Bo Jangles, you run.
This guy's got a really stout team. Stout team. I have to give that a read. Fresho. If you guys had put any of your Madden Challenge favorites in the chat, it wasn't loaded, so let me know. Emmett Smith, I don't love. I think you're better off. I would probably get Folk if I was going to stick in that price range for a legend.
Good round there.
Davis. Scuba will be commentating, so will not be in the tournament. Let's see. Got to figure out a way to slow down this inside zone ground game. See what he has available. See if he ends up going to his 3-4 normal and subbing in his strong safeties at corner. I'm not sure. All right, Bowman gets in there, makes the tackle. And Bo, just 10 carries for 32 yards. So he's holding him in check, but he's definitely got some tough yards mixed in. And a couple field goals from good field position. Two right outside linebacker upgrades. I would say for the coverage one, get the Levante David team of the week. Bo goes off the edge right there, and Night Train Lane stacks in with Bowman to make the tackle. Levante David's a good coverage, yeah. The new Sean Lee, I think he's probably too expensive at this point, but if he drops a lot.
Like, this guy's going to run. Third down on the way. Looks like they're in press
coverage here. 3rd and 9. Gibbs. Cunningham's going to take the facing four verts. He goes deep and catches it in double coverage. Michael Irvin, the playmaker.
Irvin.
46-yard catch. The guy had the halfback basically as open as you're ever going to see, and he goes into double coverage instead. And if Gibbs can hold him to a field goal, still going to be a two-score game, but we'll see what he can do here. 1st and goal. Will it be Bo Jackson? Will it be a run commit? What will happen here?
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up.
Play clock ticking down. Tosses out to the left and misses the diving tackle. Bo carries it into the end zone. Makes it 20-7. That guy going with a Wolfman read for
the deep pass.
He's going to go five wide here, or at least the four vert style route. See if he goes inside zone off of it, but 2-point conversion time. Randall and Bo and JJ Watt fighting off the edge makes
what just make it what
so Gibbs just two touchdowns away from a victory, but he's gonna have to fight. He's got Ndamukong Sue punter at quarterback. He's 10-0 in this current season, just earned his 200th mutt win of the season, and Rod Woodson says I can get you out to the 35.
Need you to be one guy.
Yes. Can't take Poe out.
Can't take Poe out.
I mean, he can take Poe out, but then he's got to hear about it forever.
I can't take Poe out. Can't take Poe out.
Best. If he takes
He's giving me a shot here.
If he takes Poe out, he's got to.
Listen, he's giving me a shot. He's saying, get the guy open. Get him open. You got a shot.
One-on-one Jerry Rice. Pick.
Doesn't have the juice. All right, we're going to have to make some big plays. He's going to run, I think.
Best linebackers for blitzing, 1,500K. I would say at that range, Aaron Lynch, or we've got some recommendations. Telvin Smith, See, they're not really blitzers. They're just fast. They need to get the playoff. All right, there's...
Timeout? No, because he's going to call another play.
Yeah. No, he's going to take it to the quarter, but...
I should call timeout.
No one know that you know. If he calls a play, he's stupid. He's going to call four verts. Let's see what...
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. One more snap, and that'll end the quarter.
Snap that ball.
Not the 93 Aaron Lynch, the one below. Merciless, decent. You got to be able to get a guy at about 97 power move and about 95 XL at that range. Team of the week, Dwight Freeney. Or not team of the week, season's veteran, Dwight Freeney, maybe. Khalil Mack, the one before the team of the week. Perhaps. The Patriots defense now is most feared. He runs it on 3rd and 13.
No
and
pass
edge
commit. Timeout,
sealed.
Right? Timeout?
Yeah.
I did not pass commit.
Not pass commit.
Because I was afraid of that very thing.
So save yourself time there. You got to score.
Before the 2-minute warning.
That would be helpful. Okay. Weird punt.
I was hoping he'd just do random things.
All right. Needs a play here. And Ndamukong Suh, a quarterback.
We're
going to
give him one shot.
Bat.
We're going to give one Wildcat Areno.
Pledge. Email me. I'll send it out to you. Spreadsheet.
One cat to the house. We need one cat to the house, boys. One, give me one cat to the house. One cat to the house.
All right, and Ndamukong pitches it out. Barry's going to get
almost that's where
to
I need
the
him.
Edge.
That's where I need you, Barry. I need you to
be fast. This guy's got a very, very good defense that Barry might run past some of those guys, but not everybody. Maybe some Freeze Armstead I like a lot, but the problem with Freeze Armstead is he came out, he was the best at what he was doing for that range. He needed to drop a little. But then the Schefter Za'Darius Smith came out, so just get Schefter Za'Darius Smith. Price considered.
I can't. I had Randall. I had Randall. That's going to come back and hurt me.
That's integrity, though. What's up, Woodster 44? Shout out. Thank you for the sub hype.
That's devastating.
That's
clock management.
That's tough. You were in done doubles for a bit. All right, so Sue. Brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go Nick Perry's good. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on Pledge the Foggs plays FUT. Yes, Pledge, let me know, man, because I know what it's like to not know exactly what FUT guys to purchase. So hit me up. I'll get you set up.
Okay. Sue's having a tough game.
Man. Shout out to Mora. 96 Sue or 94 Poe? Gibbs plays the Sue over the Poe, but he likes them both. Both really, really good items.
I was about to snap that ball, and I saw number 7. I was like, no, this cannot be right, Mr. White. I can't audible.
Yes, you are, Sir Schmittendorf.
I'm just making mistakes all.
Is he going to do it? Oh, no. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Any means necessary. You got to hustle. Because now you really got to score 42 points.
Wow.
Like, now you don't really have a choice.
No choice. Willie Rope style? And we're going to do it Willie Rope style.
Big Willie Styles all in it. Getting ropey with it.
Getting ropey with it. Do-do-do-do-do. Come on. Come on. One time for the boys in the chat. Here's the
quick toss. Got it. Broke the tackle, but needed. That is a good job. This running back known for his speed. At that time, shows a little power. And Ndamukong Suh, a quarterback, because you can. He already won a game, made his opponent quit. Suh was 4-for-4, or had a four-play drive to start the game, and then he got a pick. But this game, Suh, with his six deep accuracy, not playing well. 26 throw power.
I just want to say one thing. For when, because I know there's probably people in the chat before, they're like, this game's terrible. He's winning with Sue. Because the first game I threw that first throw, I didn't complete one pass in this game.
It's tough. Classic. He has 6 short accuracy, 6 medium accuracy. Shout out to Classic Keys for the sub hype. Let's go. Thank you very much, Classic Keys. I will get you in the brain trust tonight. Keep an eye out for your Twitch messages. That is what's up. Sue with
Woodstock goes, there's that 26 throw power.
It's going to come back and haunt you almost every single time.
Every time.
You've won a game with Drew Butler, the punter, the base draft champions punter. And you did win a game with Sue earlier.
Big Suey.
This guy just had a good lineup.
Conserve, like, he had the
you could have beat this guy too, because you gave up the touchdown at the end of the half, hurt
dumb.
You. Because then you had to kind of change, and then he had that Michael Irvin catch. If we're going back over the game, like what actually happened, you wouldn't have probably gone for it on fourth down.
I wouldn't have subbed out Cunningham in that spot, probably.
He's currently on the Browns offense, Pats defense. It's third down coming up. All right, 3rd and 7 after the 2-minute warning. We're going to be able to run the clock down a little bit here. Runs the ball. Bo Jackson takes the first hit. And then, 18 for 36 is nothing special. You've locked him up.
Yeah,
cage. But he had field position.
4 tackles for a loss with Derek Brooks.
You scored on a pick 6.
Going for it first. I was rolling the dice that he would not miss 4 throws in a row.
Yeah.
I was like, that can't happen 4 times in a row. True. Guess what happened? 4 times in a row. I don't think I completed one pass. Have I?
I think you can. I don't know. Campus Heroes is its own program, I think. Or at least it's listed that way in my head. John Ryan will be called on to send this one down the field. Which is a great site for all of your gaming needs in Madden Ultimate Team. So don't be a butthead. Go to Mudhead. Deion Sanders almost breaks one there. Right outside linebacker. Joey Porter is maybe 150K. Pernell McPhee is more of a run stopper than a zone guy.
Don't be a butthead. Go to Mudhead.com.
That
should be the commercial.
It definitely is in the Mudhead filter. It might not be in the binder filter. Was that on the quarterback, or was that just a great play by the defense? Oh, wow.
He thought that, right?
Yeah. That's not Zach Thomas. That might be six. Or seven. Out of bounds in a situation like this where you need to hurry up and make plays. The Patriots line up, split backfield. All right. We're changing things here. The quarterback
changing. He's giving the receiver Ah, come on, Sue.
2 for 12, Ndamukong Sue. Kyle Fuller, waving.
Come on, Sue.
I haven't used Aaron Lynch on that position. I probably would, though, because I don't rush. I need block shit over there and zone coverage more than anything. LT, not really there because I don't like... See, it's
what
shows Marshall Faulk is 0 for 0. Yeah, man.
Listen, I need him to throw one dot right here.
Right. If you guys aren't going to Mudhead, I'd say once a day, you're kind of making a mistake. Cody has all of the content up to date as soon as possible. It's something I check on quite a bit just to see who's out so I don't miss a day. If you miss a couple days in a row, then you start to forget who came out, what
come
came
on
out when it came out. So try and visit that at least once a day just to get your mutt bearings. Even if you're not playing the game, it still helps to notice who's playing. And then I think about a week behind, so I think, okay, Sean Lee, Football Outsiders, came out. I'm going to look to him in a week. I'm going to try and buy him 1 week from now. I don't usually... If I stay too up to date, then you're paying way too much for the items, but they usually drop a little bit, and that's what I think helps. So, you should have been able to bench Sue after 10 incompletions.
No, it's the Sue challenge. See, that's integrity. You just...
No, I'm saying he would get benched in real life. That's it.
Sue threw the game.
Literally.
He did. Things were looking good at first.
They were.
Marching down the field, then the two fumbles really killed me. I have not fumbled like that ever on the Wildcat.
Must be bad pitching. Even with that 85 awareness.
It's great awareness, but he just...
26 throw power, 6 short accuracy, 6...
I'll tell you what, accuracy. I felt all those stats.
Yeah,
6
I couldn't, throw on the run.
I couldn't... That run hurt me.
I'm guessing they don't want you to do that if they put him at 6, because I've never seen it lower than like 12.
Yeah, 6 is really bad.
It's tough. Good call by Hoshugs. Great tip in the chat about Ultimate Team. He says, limited cards are usually the cheapest the day they drop due to people trying to cash out. So if you pull them, a lot of people will try and get rid of them thinking that they're going to be the most valuable right then. But once you wait and those cards and items find teams that like they want to call home, perhaps then it settles because then there's less... free ones on the market, per se.
Sue couldn't handle the playoff pressure.
That's a Shug's tip right there.
Not a good day for Sue.
3 for 14, 0 passer rating.
20%.
6 for 9. Show me the Hail Mary.
No, it's 3 for 14.
What happened? Come clean on the Hail Mary. What'd you do?
I played zone.
But then what?
Shouldn't have played zone. I was in the show blitz. And I didn't I didn't recognize that he was in Hail Mary. Like I thought he was just like a trips tight end set. That was a mental mistake. That literally mental mistake there. Like I know if I'm in Hail Mary, like I shouldn't have been in that defense anyways. I don't know where it is.
It's right there, 15 seconds.
This one?
Yeah.
See, I didn't recognize that this was Hail Mary set. Like I thought it was like always in trips.
Right.
And so because of that, like you never, like everyone knows, and I brought the safety up a little bit on the left. So when you face that slot, see how he's on the line of scrimmage, like he gets out there going quick. Like he gets on the deep secondary quick and there's nothing I could do there. He'd already won that battle. And I was a man because I was fully anticipating him running the verticals play where 86
right.
runs the deep cross and then 84 runs like the slanted cross. But instead they all just run streaks.
And they're good.
Terrible matchup there.
Right. Wait, that was zone.
There was zone, but I manned them up.
I see.
I played cover 3. I was like pressure, and pressure.
Aligned and I got it. Okay.
It was a mental mistake.
The night train thing was good.
Yeah.
but just that the passing was tough. And the fact he couldn't even really pitch the Wildcat hurt you. Two turnovers.
Pressure's good. So there's no separation, and he threw, like, he my guess is that he didn't use a pass lead.
Right.
Or he used a pass lead, like, down and away rather than up. But still, that's a, you can't make that throw. But pressure's coming in, so he made it anyways.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He kind of got contextually aware when he broke. Against Watt. J.J. Watt had a good game for you.
Yeah, he did. Yeah.
He's pretty legit. All right, dudes. That is all for this week in Madden. Show 178. That's that many weeks in a row.
So, question. Did I succeed or did I fail? It was like I succeeded.
You technically won the first game.
So I succeeded in the QB challenge. And then I played a second game for fun.
You kind of failed it. You didn't really fail it. Sue kind of failed it.
Sue failed it. So we did the review of Sue at quarterback.
Yeah.
Not a good option.
Yeah, you're gonna want to go away from that.
We're gonna talk about that in the Muttcast next week. Real quick, guys in the chat.
Yes, W Pool. Yes, it is worth that, I would say. Yes. Because look at it on the stray hand and look how much that costs.
Guys in the chat, if you're...
This chat's working.
Your computer not loaded very often?
I don't know. Are we going to host?
No.
A little Muttcast? Yeah, if you guys missed the Muttcast from yesterday, we had Mutt Guru on there talking. We had RG. We also had the commish. If you're interested in the Madden Challenge, this is one you don't want to miss. If you guys need Team of the Week review, you can head over to youtube.com/zfarls. We'll set you up with that. For the Brain Trust guys, keep an eye out for an email tonight to get access to the Brain Trust and get everything in there, the 335 odd D, the Titan scheme, that Wildcat scheme, which will work if you don't have a quarterback as a punter.
I got to be getting a season's vet sometime soon. I've been putting those things in there for months.
Hopefully. So that was a 10-0 season.
I did get my 200th win, though. I'm glad to see 200.
It's pretty good.
Yeah. Now I got a clean slate. I can retire Sue as my quarterback.
Yeah.
So, yeah. There you go.
All right. Is anybody live, or should we go over to Black Phoenix? Or are you going to go?
No. I think J.O. will be coming up. J.O. will be coming up tonight.
All right.
So.
Keep an eye out there. We'll host Black Phoenix for a little bit. Let's see if you want to type it in over there. We'll get that up.
Yep.
And, boom. All right, until next week, next Wednesday, guys, lock up. Send in your questions at any time. You can check my Twitter to find where to put your questions.
Check our tweet.
I think it's TwimQ, and we'll do that.
Mm-mm-mm.
That's not it. All right. All right, guys, we're going to head over and watch some Black Phoenix, and then we'll talk to you next Wednesday.
See ya. Give me some.